Okay. As you came in, I said, "Hey, oh fucking slut." Then I said, "Oh, he can't hear me." Then Josh fucking said it. Then That's I funny. Reiterated it because he said it slightly wrong. And now we're here. So, Gage, for your information and for the other fuckers above you, except for the other Josh and Dustin, when we don't have my sessions, we have Pathfinder. When we have Pathfinder, we don't have my sessions.
But we don't have a session of
it
yours
flops.
This week.
Bah.
Correct. It flops every other week.
For some reason, I thought we had a session last week, and that's my bad.
Nope.
Yeah. It's
yeah, it doesn't feel like 2 weeks this time.
Of course. It really hasn't.
Last time it was
like
a month, so.
It's been, yeah, that's a good point. We did have a pretty big break before that.
Yeah.
Plus, like, shit's really been hard to keep track of lately.
Yeah.
Dustin and Jacob, what fucking episode are we on?
Four?
I already had it,
I feel like it's four.
It's not four, it's six.
I was gonna say
six,
we're on.
Six, goddamn!
I was gonna say we were on five last time.
Correct.
Jacob, did you think it was four too?
I thought it was five.
Oh. Okay.
We can't keep track of shit.
Yep, it is six. I started posting all of them. Unfortunately, I did not get episode 2 and 1 because those have out.
Well,
I don't care that much about that stuff.
I have them.
Jacob.
Yes.
Are we using Talespire today?
Possibly, probably.
Just on standby, basically.
Yeah. I have it for pretty pictures and festival thing, but it's not required.
I'll just have it on standby. Might as well.
Okay, what is this? Blood and sand.
Austin, I'm starting to become a collectible person.
What do you mean?
I just bought... Let's see. How many miniatures did I buy yesterday? Like, almost 20? And I bought another set of... And I bought another set of that. To be fair, 15 of those are like a really like small like bundle set, like they're nothing too major, but I bought some specialty ones as well on top of the 15 zombies that I bought.
15 zombies.
Yep. Did I tell you about that? What I'm doing? Well, so I don't know if I thought I told you about it before, Austin, but
nope.
I'm doing a one shot for everybody in my house right now, or I'm going to once everybody's done with their character sheets.
Yeah, you mentioned this actually.
Yeah,
I remember
it did.
Now.
Yeah. So I need lots of zombies.
Zombies.
If you run out of minis, you can use
you
pieces of candy
use,
and reward the players
M&Ms.
For killing them.
No, I agree. I'm just saying.
Just use M&Ms because then they can kill them and then eat the M&M.
But they were, they were like $6 for a pack of five. So I just bought three.
That's pretty good.
Let's see. Roll 20. That's fine.
What else did I buy? I bought a flesh golem. I bought an undead beyonder.
You're a bastard.
And I bought
a flesh golem at them.
What else did I buy?
Flesh golem to only be hurt by
something
magic.
Else. I think it was a troll of some kind, like a zombie troll
Gage,
or something.
Gage, I want you to think about it. What is your party dynamic? Because if you throw a flesh golem at a party that has no magical damage, they're going to die. You want to know how we know
damage.
This? You want to know how we know this?
We lost two people.
We lost two PCs in the last campaign.
Almost three.
So, a couple things. One, yes, we have at least one spellcaster so far. Two, the other thing about this one shot is because it's primarily combat focused, like these guys are probably going to end up getting lots of legendary items, so it kind of balances itself out.
Okay, as long as just make sure they have magic damage was the big thing, Jade.
I have a plan, no worries.
Plans on
because you will kill them.
I warned you it was going to be a difficult fight.
Yes, you did.
I mean, listen, I will say I did warn them ahead of time. Like, it's going to be combat focused and I'm going to throw shit at you because it's going to balance out. Like, trust me. I know a lot of them are new, but it'll get them, you know, acclimated to, like, more challenging combat.
I'm just saying, some of them will literally be useless if they're fighters.
Unless they have
a don't have a magic weapon. Sword.
Mm.
But that's why we're working on. That's why I've got plans for that.
Jacob
threw a dragon at these motherfuckers yesterday.
We almost died.
Dear God.
Legitimately, I was the only one still alive by the end of the combat.
Three of us are dodges.
Oh, dear God.
Well, two breath weapon attacks.
I managed to piss it off, so it was very central focused on killing me for the longest time.
What dragon did you throw at them?
Purple.
Purple.
You threw a purple dragon at him? Oh my
god. We're level 5, by the way.
Why did you throw a level 5 purple dragon at them?
We killed it.
Because he's a statistic bastard, also because we've been hot in our britches and killing everything else.
I've been... It's a very homebrewed campaign based on a book series that I like. And so I homebrew a lot of the monsters, and they have recently, ever since they hit level 5 and most of them fuckers got multi-attack, have been killing everything with impunity. So I wanted to give them something something challenging.
Fair enough.
And so I threw a dragon, a slightly nerfed dragon.
Okay. Adult dragon.
Slightly nerfed purple dragon. And when I mean slightly nerfed, I mean 12 health and 2d10 off of the breath weapon.
And I knocked 25% of the damage potential off of its breath weapon.
Yeah. Holy fuck, dude.
If he had not done the 2d10 off the breath weapon, we would have probably had at least 2 fatalities.
Did you say 12 HP on that thing?
He knocked 12 HP off. It had 250
some.
Its average for the roll is 262, and I just gave it 250.
Mm.
Yeah.
Nice, solid number.
Yeah, we literally did half its health in the first turn, and then piddle damage after that, and we started dying.
That sucks.
The funniest thing is that there were so many natural ones and so many natural 20s.
Ooh.
God. I pissed it off.
Eight natural ones. Eight natural ones.
God.
Five natural 20s.
It sounded like Shadow's first fucking, first game with him.
Well, the thing is, he wasn't the one rolling the natural ones. He rolled 1.
No, but I'm saying, like...
No, I rolled more than 1 nat 1. Because I rolled nat 1s for... No, I rolled that ones for the dragon, for Chak, and for Silva.
I guess I wasn't counting Chak and Silva.
Mm. Mm-hmm. There were a lot.
I was gonna say it was retribution for the first game that I played with you guys in Pathfinder, and fucking Shadow rolled like, what was it, 5 natural ones in a row?
That's right. 5 natural ones.
No, that's just fucking normal rolls for me.
The funniest thing was it was spread out to everyone, but like. There was a karma balance to it all, the entire time. Legitimately, the third attack that I did in the combat, I literally went over and like, I'm gonna put my gun to the base of this fucking guy's skull as I'm looking over top of him, basically straight down shot. How could I miss? Natural 20. And then he died. I dropped to the ground on top of his body. I then shoot the next guy. Natural 1. But that's the severity awful. For the entire night until the end, the last 2 severities were the worst ones, and they were only 55s.
Shit.
Yep.
So, Jacob, are you ready, and do you need more time to put more things?
Nope, I am pretty much ready. I think.
My stream's up.
I'm ready.
What the
fuck?
Well, I'm gonna bother streaming.
Motherfucker. Might as well. Bitch.
I wanna eat.
Eat and stream. Don't give a shit.
Don't give a shit.
I do it. Don't give a shit. I'm oh so successful.
Oh so.
I'm an affiliate.
What's that?
It means I used to have people that watch the streams. Now I don't.
Hey, you still have Vade, don't you?
Ooh.
Every now and then.
I see progress on this map. Oh my lord!
Did you say oh my lord?
Oh my lord!
Oh wait, Talespire?
Ooh!
I mean, you don't need to be.
Oh!
I'll open Talespire because ambiance.
Oh my mama. And it even had the sign that Thompson was leaning on as the homeless man.
That's fixed with a shitty rope.
Yeah.
I definitely.
Sadly, there was no like sign held up with chain or anything. So that's what I had.
Yeah. Oh well.
Gaspire doesn't have mod support, does it?
Not yet.
I don't think.
It really should add that.
I think it's one of the things they're working on right now, actually.
That would be
that people can customize blocks and shit and mod in stuff they want.
Yep.
This was Thompson's. Dev,
ooh, okay, okay, okay.
Is this the tavern?
Jacob saw my map from yesterday and was just like, nah, fuck you, I need to one-up you.
He's probably been working on this before then.
Yeah.
I'm not done yet.
It still looks very good.
Ooh, look at me, I'm not done yet. What, do I have to make the entire fucking city of Bulkpan to make you people happy?
That's no. The
what are you, Matthew Mercer?
Do it.
I was like, when did your world feel done? He's like, it still doesn't. This motherfucker can say that with a straight face while he holds two books of source material. I got like 3 seasons in between. I got 3 months in between sessions, and I go, "Welcome to Flagnum Blanks. It's time for the happy dance." That's it. That's all I got. Fucking, I love Brennan. I love Brennan.
Brennan Lee Mulligan is iconic.
I sent you another TikTok that
I saw.
That is like, I love that. I should send that to Jacob because he would love that line too.
Alright, so I just need to double check the name of the fucking tavern you're in real quick.
Oh.
It's in my notes.
Double check the name of the fuckening.
I know the fuckening. General store is the corrupted wolf.
The general store is the corrupted wolf.
I just can't remember the tavern name.
Come on. Benji.
My internet's a little slow, so please bear patience with me.
It's all good.
Violet Queen Inn.
Nothing.
What at all?
No, that is unacceptable. You have to have the fastest internet.
The Violet Queen Inn. So, question: who is the first one to be awake and go through the inn?
I'm not at the inn, so not me.
When does Thompson end?
I'm an elf, so I probably didn't. I mean, I don't sleep, so yeah, I'd probably be the first one awake.
Okay. So, Gage, as you walk through the bar, the bartender would call you over.
Okay.
He goes, over there. So, Thompson was in earlier this morning, and he said he forgot to give you information on some kind of mystical creatures or beings or some shit. I don't fucking know. Half of what that man says sounds like fucking gibberish to me anyways. So, he said whenever you got time today, if you want to swing by, he can give you what you need.
Well, thank you for letting me know. I'll be sure to inform my fellow party members. While I'm here, do you mind if I get some breakfast?
Of course. What tickles your fancy this morning?
Can you remind me what that kind of shit costs?
For higher end stuff, it depends on what you get, but basic bitch platter is a silver.
Yeah, we'll just do a basic platter.
Man, can't even treat himself at breakfast.
Listen,
we are basic.
The most important meal of the day.
Awen is a fucking cheapskate.
We are poor.
So as you are,
who are these
eating,
wee people?
As you're eating your breakfast, you notice that the tavern is like it's packed in there right now, dude. For a little town's festival, there's a lot of people in here.
Okay. I'll kind of be like, you know, I heard about this festival, but I didn't think it would attract this many people.
Well, there was a when it first started off at the Capitol, they really didn't handle the fireworks with much care. Mm. And a lot of buildings kind of burned down.
I see.
So, since we're kind of in the middle of nowhere, we can get it away with a lot more.
Mm. So you have people coming from all over.
Watch us blow shit up, yes. Mm.
Sounds like a good time. I look forward to seeing more.
Apparently the rules for laws changed or something. It's changed my thing. It changed my character sheet up, apparently. So, sorry, I didn't interrupt him.
Ambiance!
Oh, that wasn't set originally?
No.
Oh, it's set now.
It is indeed.
I thought it was set the entire fucking time. I thought.
I think it has to set. I think it has to set because I see it
when I change everything. But if I don't hit the button, I still see and hear it. But you guys don't do it, so I thought it was active.
Interesting.
On your guys' end.
It's all good.
Alright. Well, I suppose I'll just wait, continuing my breakfast until everybody else gets there.
Alright. Alright, party would slowly wake up on their own time.
Yep. I have to do something to get my gun.
Hey.
I'll go down to the bar and get some chow.
Jacob, what do I see as I'm walking back into town?
From last night to this morning, the town was basically dead, right? Only the people who really lived there had houses, and there's the one tavern, right?
Yeah.
There's basically a small tent encampment outside of town now.
Did they make up tent around me while I was just staring up the stars? Because they already saw me here?
No.
Okay. I was just wondering.
That
would have
been funny.
That would have been funny.
Because I think you went up on a hill, so they went to more flattish area.
Yeah.
Can I have both? Yes, I can. I will have food.
You will have food?
As will I.
You will have food as well?
Yeah. Send us a silver.
Yep, it is a silver.
I'll walk to the tavern now that I'm back into town to catch up with the party.
Just a cute little baby.
As you make your way through the town, you'll notice various stands. There's a lot of food stands to one side. It looks like there's some people doing target practice, showing off for their skills and stuff, because it is a festival to celebrate basically gunpowder.
Guns. Isn't it fire as well?
Or is it just fire gunpowder? Crafting and gunpowder.
Fire crafting and gunpowder.
Yeah, so that's why they have most, basically all, there's no, how would you say, raw food. Everything has been cooked to some degree. Around the blacksmith shop, you'll see a few artisans, but probably not as many as you would see in more, the larger cities.
Actually, if I see artisans, I'm going to stroll through and see kind of what they are all offering, seeing what quality they have.
It's mostly pottery, kind of higher-end stuff that doesn't really get brought out here very often. Because most times you can't really make a profit on it out here. But bring it out during a festival and you could probably, you know, make it worth your while.
So are we saying everybody's at the tavern now, or
anybody else? I am.
Same.
I won't speak for everyone else, but I'm there.
I am.
Josh, too, are you here as well?
Yeah, I am. You're very quiet, good sir.
Yes, you are quite silent.
I'm sorry.
You're fine.
All right. Well,
I'm there.
With that being said, if I've got everybody around me, I'll relay the information that I was told this morning. Thompson wants us to see him before we enjoy our festivities. He's got some more information about, what did you say? It was like some sort of, it's escaping me now. My brain is still not 100% here.
Some sort of mystical creature.
Right.
Yes, of course. That is information that will help us greatly.
All right. Well, I say we all get finished with our breakfast and head straight over.
Yes. I had to go over there anyway to pick up my gun.
Right.
That's right.
Thank you again, good bartender, for the excellent food as always.
Thank
you. Oh, don't thank me. I don't cook.
Well, give... compliments to the chef.
I shall tell my wife.
Did you already forget it was his wife?
We have a conversation every 2 weeks on this, Austin.
That's fair.
All right, let's head over to Thompson's then.
It has been a while since I've seen. So many people have fun.
Do you know if it lasts an interval?
What'd you say?
Do you know how to relax?
Well... No.
says the guy who's practically holding a knife to his throat.
I suppose that you would have... whatchamacallit? People out and about, but we can't see them because we don't have minis on the field.
Well, I believe all of your minis are in Thompson's right now.
No.
Oh.
Okay,
no,
that's where they were last.
Think they might have gotten cleared?
May have gotten cleared. Oh, probably because I was messing with his house. Ah. Alright.
And I like how the paths, there's paths in the sand for where people travel. Or at least there's one from Thompson to the jail. Hey!
Oh, look at all the people!
Oof.
Wait, oh, that's right, because you can't see any of them because you don't have a character on the board.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I always fucking forget that.
God, Jacob, you put so much work in this. I'm so appreciated.
Look,
it's the Nara. We have to stab her.
Wait, where?
Wait, you threw a Nara?
Oh my god,
what?
Elias is there?
It definitely looks like at least the old menu when she had.
Oh, the original with the beer? Yeah.
Oh,
and I lost my boar.
No!
No!
There it is.
Fuck you, internet.
Tally number one.
It begins.
The shitternet strikes again.
The shitternet. Thank you.
What the fuck was that?
Oh, Jacob's back!
Back.
Dart has returned to the board. God damn it.
It was for naught.
And he's back! Okay.
There we go.
He's back! Awesome's in the tension, he'll be back in a second.
Where are we at? That noon. Oh, son of a fucking, just stay connected.
A board that's too good, to can't handle it.
Did he get back and leave again? Dude, my Tailspire crashed 3 times making that map yesterday.
Good God.
It, with all the updates and changes, because they basically update it fucking weekly, problems tend to occur.
Yeah. I don't like the Gravedigger, though. That's slightly.
He just saw the grave digger.
Yeah, he's slightly concerning.
Required for fact.
Let's see.
You're talking about the two guys, or at least two guys I can see running around with a shovel, right?
Oh yeah. Oh.
Oh, that's not what I.
It's a shovel in a sack.
Yes.
And he kind of looks more like a grave robber than a grave digger.
You know.
He looks like either Lemony Snicket or the guy who hates Christmas, Scrooge.
You know, with how far inland we are, it's really neat to see the
Scrooge.
It's really neat to see a fish. Both of them hate Christmas. It's okay.
Okay.
I'm sorry, but is he bright fucking green?
I don't know who you're talking about.
But I'm missing someone.
I'll answer that. No.
There we go.
What did I say when many? Dage?
Huh? What?
What did I say when many? With all the talk.
Thank you.
Am I the ghost?
It was very fitting. I didn't even know they had.
Yes, because you remember you wear the ghost costume, and I don't have anything else for you.
Oh, I thought I had a mask. That's okay.
If you have a jester, you can use that now as a mask.
Yeah. I have the one I need.
Yo, you actually put one in?
Well, yeah. It's not connected to the board yet.
Yeah. So press space at the bottom left. There's that orange tab. Click that, then click the mini.
Spinning.
Right. I clicked it. Wait, do I like? Okay. And it's got like a. It's like highlighted in orange, right?
Maybe.
It's slowly rotating. It looks so.
Yeah, it's an orange tab.
Glorious.
Oh my God.
It should be highlighted in orange, and there should be a chain link on it.
Yeah. Should be. It's okay. Like, don't like hold section.
Alright, we'll fuck around with this later. Ghost for now. Suck it up!
Ooh, spooky.
Well, yeah, is this the first time they're seeing... Oh, no, you showed off the mask the other night.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'm pimping, walking
big
around.
Pimpin'.
Big pimping, massive.
Oh. Alright.
Massive.
So you walk into Thompson's. He looks up at you and goes, "Ah! Finally, I thought you'd sleep in all day."
What was it you wanted to see us about, Thompson?
Well, I realized that when we talked yesterday, I forgot to tell you about the Sand Devils.
It's true, we did ask for information.
Yes.
I'm ready.
Which is why he wasn't very specific at the bar. With the messenger then.
Yeah.
Oh, I just really like fucking with him, honestly. So as you know, there are 6 lords and ladies and the king. I can't tell you what they look like. And well, except for the one that's currently missing a chunk of his head, you already know what he looks like. Why can't I tell you what they look like? Well, they're made of sand. And sand has a tendency to move around. They don't look the same, is what I'm saying. from one encounter to the next. I can just give you general tendencies that they have been observed in.
That's fucking terrifying, Jacob.
Wait,
Hazard is ever shifting. Ever changing.
Is that made of sand? If you heat them up, can you make glass?
They're immortal, Josh.
Yeah, but glass is fragile. They're still immortal. People. They have to reform.
That would only work if they're in their shifting shape, and also it's not considered magical glass. Or your fire stronger than their magical glass. Logical sand.
This is a question for Thompson. Did you like make them into glass if you breathe, if you hit them with a hot enough flame?
Sure, but do you really want to attempt to fight a sand monster or a glass monster?
Glass has more form. Glass won't part between a blade. Sand will.
Glass is also ready.
I guess you'll
sharp
see how well that
pointed
works out for you. No, won't we?
I have no intention of fighting what any time soon.
Sand can choke you out, whereas glass can cut you like a fish.
Cut you like a fish. That's
hey,
a way to describe
move
it.
On. So,
I'm sorry.
Say,
both
I'm,
variations.
I'm sorry, I was a lizard man. I'm pretty partial to fish.
You could do this. So, first one is Lord Tommy Skinner, is his full name. He is known as a mastered swordsman, and he loves to be challenged to duels.
Fuck.
One on six, whatever. He loves dueling people. Official duels or otherwise, if it spreads far and wide enough that there's a duel going on somewhere, there's a good chance he will show up.
Excellent.
Getting that off the hobby list.
Lord George Pittman. He's a cleric. He's probably one of the most devoted holy men that we can know of. He has a tendency to be caught sneaking into masses of churches quite often. And like I said, information is scarce, but they're fanatics in one way or another. And that's basically how you can tell who you might be dealing with.
No duels, no religion, you got it, Thompson. Going to church on Sundays.
Our computer. Want to change the wording here real quick. Save changes. That's not... What? Huh? Nope, that's definitely not what I wanted. What? I love it when the... God, world, and well, sometimes you make me mad. Okay. So, Lady Grey. She is an assassin. And if you know her, she's there. She wants you to know she's there. Otherwise, she is no different than a shadow. Have fun with that in your nightmares, really.
Seems like we can do anything about it. She doesn't want us to know, so why worry?
Gray shadow. Nice, nice.
It said Lady Black.
Gray sounds better.
Yeah. So,
gonna butcher this. Lord Elvos Mifelcum, the gentleman you had recently met. Crazy. Mad scientist. That's all you really need.
I don't think I'm getting his voice out of my head anytime soon.
I don't think I'm getting the feel of his hand around my neck off of me anytime soon.
Shoulder.
Shoulder, whatever. Felt like it was on the neck.
With the skeleton, is this? It's close enough.
Still exaggeration.
Lord Bradley Richards. So the one distinctive characteristic we know about this guy, he's unable to change his very large size. He loves fighting, and he gets stronger the longer he's in combat.
Oh no!
You brought him back,
damn.
You bastard! You brought him back!
I love him.
You, okay. You bastard!
This is the motherfucker bastard. That had the wolf, isn't it?
Yeah.
Really? The chain devil guy?
No, the werewolf thing.
No, the werewolf leader.
Oh!
He also grew in size whenever he got into a good fight.
Okay.
Great, now I get to experience him.
Well, we never fought him. He was actually our friend.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, well, most of us never fought him, namely me. Everyone else managed to piss them off.
Hey, fucking excuse me?
Elias got thrown out, remember?
That was Elias. Wander, on the other hand, he's a peach.
So does the dueling one fight the fighting one fairly often, or do they just exist separately?
One is just likes to fight the fight. The other one is to test the skill. So they fight for different reasons, and because of that, sometimes, yeah, they've been known to engage in duels, but they find different kinds of opponents more interesting.
Alright.
Alright. And the last... Oh, sorry, did someone have a question?
Nope.
Okay. Last one, Lady Rosa Weaver. So out of all of the Sand Devils, Lady Weaver is the most reasonable. However, she lives in the Delta.
Ho ho!
Being a druid. And a high level one at that. Basically, as far as we can understand, her curse, or her penance, for watching her empire stalk the land is to forever guard the Delta. That's one of the reasons why you don't go into the Delta.
Quick question. You said the king was one of those. Which one was the king?
None of those.
You said
no one has ever met him and lived.
Wonderful. No information, period. Love to hear.
I mean, you could take some extrapolations from history if you really want, but of course, it's history on a king.
Exaggerated.
Could be.
Done by the people other than him.
Could be. It could be either very exaggerated or very toned down to hide information. They were in a expansionist warring period at that time. Basically, if you're not us, you are either non-existent or under us. Most empires were at that point.
Well.
Thank you, Captain.
You're welcome. I hope this fills your dreams with nightmares instead.
You got my gun?
Did I get your gun? Yes, I got you fucking gun.
I figured you had it. You just started talking about a lot of danger. You think that wouldn't feel safer with the gun? It might not do much, but...
It might not do much. You're lucky if it'll do anything.
As she will hand you a rifle.
Yep. I went ahead and added the blood powder rifle to my... The yep. flintlock mustard.
Well, is there anything else you need from us, Mr. Thompson?
Nope, you've got your jobs. Enjoy the festival. Yeah. Leave town. Have fun.
We did sign the contract, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I assumed after you accepted the job, you would have just signed, so I didn't go through the hullabaloo.
Okay.
Alrighty. I guess let's go enjoy the festival then.
Oh, Mr. Niccolo, you were saying you were wanting to get a messenger out to Iron Ghost, so that way the sheriffs had some idea of our incoming with potential bag of ears.
That would be appreciated. I have
you
a feeling they would appreciate that.
Assume that's the weirdest thing they would see all day.
It's more from our previous encounters. He's trying to build a good repertoire.
I love this new southern drawl you've put on Gats.
Our reputation with them is not the best, so I thought some forewarning would help to improve it.
Alright, you gonna pay for the messenger?
Yes. I can do that.
Alright. Write up a letter, and I'll see if I can't find a runner who's willing to leave town on the day of a festival.
I'll take it.
You could have them send the message the next day.
Yes.
You gotta think.
Okay,
the festival lasts 5 days.
Oh.
Are we staying for like the entire week, or like what are we doing?
I thought that was the plan.
I thought we were gonna stay here a day and then deal with the bandits.
That's what I thought.
That was my assumption as well.
Yeah. I thought we were saying
it's only for the day, Austin.
Oh, is it only for the day? Oh,
yeah. Fireworks show.
It was like a week long festival.
And I lost connection again.
Oh no.
I can't remember.
Oh. Any problems?
I intended it to be a day. I know other festivals are longer.
I believe it is called the Day of Fire Festival.
That's fair.
That's true.
In fact.
It's been mad facts.
Well, the message can be held until tomorrow.
Alright, see if I can't round someone up who's willing to take it out tomorrow.
Thank you, Thompson.
I guess bring it to me later. Message later tonight.
Will do.
All right. What do you want to do?
By the way, Gage, I love the fact that when you pointed out my accent, Justin had to change his accent back from one of his other characters into his actual one for this campaign.
Well, what?
You were doing...
Was I doing Kubo?
You were doing Kubo initially, and then when he pointed out that I was doing a Southern, you immediately changed it to Niccolo's.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
So if you did that accidentally, that's fucking funny.
That's really funny.
Subconsciously.
I guess I do need to take... better pains. My mouth did feel a bit weird as I was talking. It felt weird.
You heard it here
Gats
first, boys. His mouth felt
draw.
Weird.
Gats has always had a southern draw. It's just I'm putting a little more emphasis on it because I wasn't doing too heavy on it.
Yeah.
So.
Alright. Well, I'm probably going to head back out, just kind of survey the festival, but I might maybe later in the day start doing my little showman thing that I do to make some more money, since, you know, it's a festival.
Right.
I might follow A1 as well. we can help him with that.
Just have, oh my god. Oh my god, I could straight up, like, use you to just, like, draw in, like, more of a crowd and stuff like that, especially with, like, your outfit now.
Something clicks inside Mr. Bones that he's never felt before.
He's now a jester, boys!
Woohoo! He's now a straight up jester.
Oh, also, kind of, like, as we're going, I want to see, like, if there's, like, you know, like trash usually is, like, thrown into, like, alleyways. I wanna, like, if I see any, like, bones or anything, because I haven't sated myself in a while. I wanna, like, kind of maybe see, like, passively. Yeah.
Okay. If you wanna just... Oh, there's already someone in that tent. I can just delete that character. What is your passive perception?
Do they have that in this game?
Pretty sure they do.
I don't believe they do.
Oh, they don't.
Yeah, there's no passive perception.
Look and you're rolling.
I look and roll.
There's a passive wisdom.
You find four meager bones.
Four meager. I kind of step off to the side. Grab them quick.
We'll say. Here, you know what? Just for shits and giggles. Yeah, we're gonna say I notice you doing that.
Oh, no.
That's a +7 right there. +7 to 15. I'm just gonna notice him, like, kind of shirking off, grabbing these things and coming back, and I'll be like, Mr. B, what are you doing?
For Mr. B, I swear to God.
Right. And I'll just kind of, like, keep walking.
Kind of, like, flip up the mask.
Funny.
It's like Scooby Snacks all over again. Like, I swear, just for Scoob.
I swear.
Jacob, is there any feats of strength or other contests about?
Yes, there are.
What we got?
Well, there looks like to be a ring where they have something akin to a wrestling match going on in the center of town.
Oh, perfect.
Over on the side, there seems to be dueling going on. But if you were to watch long enough, every once in a while they'll set the practice swords and weapons off to the side. And every once in a while, someone will do an arm wrestling contest on the table.
I'll go to that one.
Hold it.
Fucking knew he would.
Alright. Let's see.
Now let's see if they allow me to enter for using performance enhancing body enhancement.
Performance-enhancing body enhancement.
At least I don't think they piss test, so you should be okay there.
I don't piss, so. Is that a good thing or not?
Word of the day, I don't piss.
I don't piss.
Oh, yeah, we do have a quote chat. Perfect.
Just need a little scrap of paper.
To the quote channel.
You're cheating! He has no ball sack drag!
Austin. Come up against an average looking man. Hit me with a roll.
I'd
athletics.
I'm just gonna crack all my joints. And then
your metallic flex. Joints.
Yeah. Athletics or strength?
Assuming athletics.
Okay. Find my goddamn gut. Skills, there we go. Cool. +9
All right.
How far out of the ring does he go?
That's a 15. So you just kind of go, wham! He's like, okay, all right.
Oh, this will be an interesting thing for Justin. I just remember because you said that there's training weapons.
Yep.
Oh yeah, dueling.
So now Gats's actual sword fighting style will come up.
Oh god.
All right, Austin, you have a slightly more well-built gentleman up next. If you wish to continue,
I will shake his hand.
All right.
And then assume the position.
Assume the position.
Fire.
Oh my god! The trend continues!
How does a 29 sound to you, Jacob?
Oh my god!
There's technically no crits. Remember, there's no crits.
No, 20 doesn't mean anything.
But here's the thing. It's the degrees of success. So, since you succeeded, that's still a critical success.
Mm. Right.
Yep.
Because you beat him by one on that one.
Oh, he had a much higher strength than I do, then.
A very well-built man, as I said. Okay. The first guy only had 6.
I only have a 9.
He had a 10. He had one.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. He had a 10.
One high.
Yeah.
Now let's see if a certain man heard about the festival.
That's what I'm afraid of. That's what I was afraid of.
Oh no. Come on.
All right, Austin.
That's what,
even or odd.
Is that odd?
Oh wow.
You lucky man.
Austin, wow. Was the whole sad devil. If he won, that would have been hilarious.
No, then we'd all died.
Yeah.
Not all of us.
I don't think he would have taken that very kindly. He would have gotten bigger.
Josh, not all of us. I don't know you.
And Austin, from the 2 matches, you won 7 silver.
Oh, I'm no longer at 69 gold. I'm just gonna keep it at silver. Right. I'm keeping that 69 gold for as long as I can.
Alright, I'm just gonna go down my list here. Actually, since we started towards the bottom with Gats, Mr. B is going with, I think it was Awen. So I guess, Awen, where are you going?
So, like I said, I've been kind of just taking stock of everything. I guess I'll roll like a, just like a general perception to just kind of take stock of everyone around me, see what I notice about everybody, if there's any like suspicious characters, anything like that. Just take general stock of the crowd. 18.
No one seems overly suspicious to you, being earlier in the day. People haven't really started drinking yet, so everyone's kind of very well attentive and just kind of having a good time. As you are walking around, you would notice, like I said, food stalls, the competition shooting, the arm wrestling you saw Gats doing, probably from across the way. And in the tent over here, you will notice is kind of a bookstore, like.
Oh, bookstore. I'll check out the bookstore.
Get out of the bookstore? All right.
Yeah.
That's kind of follow me.
All right, let's see. You gotta see who I put in the bookstore. Alright, you would come in to a lady desperately trying to keep the sand away and off of some of her books and not really succeeding, like, at all.
That's funny.
She's got books, she's got scrolls, she's got bundles of parchment that are only being kept down with a couple of stones you probably just found on the ground inside a town.
All right. I'll just kind of, you know, look like I'm kind of looking around at all the different items she's got and be like, quite the nice setup you got here.
I wouldn't call it nice, but thank you.
My name's Awen, by the way. Nice to meet you.
I didn't name this character? Fuck you.
Jacob, you should know by now.
I'm ready for the name.
Here it comes.
Oh, you're gonna...
He's been doing this. He even did a random citizen number 7.
For the one who told us about the Day of Fire Festival. Yes.
What's your story?
Where do you come from?
What's your motivation?
What's your life?
How was your childhood?
How's the family? Are they good?
Listen,
do they live in town? What's your mother's name?
I can't bargain with her if I don't know who she is.
Have you ever heard of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ?
Yeah, but it's less fun that way.
Hey, why are you asking bank questions over there, Austin? What's your mother's name?
No reason. I'm not trying to fish for social security numbers.
Oh, I was just getting ready to ask, what is your social security number?
We're gonna go with
what if I was,
Allison.
What would it be?
Allison. Is she human? Like, what race is she?
She is human.
Your mother.
Your mother.
Sorry. What I get for being a DM.
Well... Oh, you know, tents can be nice. What kind of, what are some items that you recommend?
It depends on what you're looking for. I have some history stuff. I have some basic, not magic books. I have some archaeological texts. Nothing too out of the way. Josh, I see your hand now.
Miss, can I ask, what's a book?
Good lord. I apologize. He had a very sheltered childhood.
He was dropped in the head.
Well, it's usually the sheltered ones have more books, not
books.
Well, you'd be surprised.
I think I, like, pick up, like, a book. It's kind of like, what are all these characters for?
He can't read.
I don't know how to read.
Can't read.
Tries to eat the book.
I have a pretty high intelligence too. I just don't.
It's a book, an instrument.
You could learn to read in a weekend, but you just haven't.
Probably could pick it up pretty easily.
That means he's just been. He hasn't got any food. He hasn't had to point at random things on the menu and know that one.
That one.
There's no menus, that's why.
She will rummage around and give Mr. B a dictionary.
Will this help me to understand these characters?
Yes, it gives... With someone with you, they could help explain, because this book has definitions of all all the words in the common language.
I'll lean over to Mr. B, like, make sure you read it with Gats. He's very good with books.
Oh, okay. I kind of want to start like looking over it and like trying to figure out what the words mean, and I think I'll just like start speaking in natural.
That's not terrifying the bookkeeper at all.
I'll just kind of try to get us back on track. How much for the dictionary, miss?
It's on the house. I think he needs it more than I do.
That's understandable. So you just just letting him kind of do his thing. So you come to the festival for selling these books. I'm assuming you're quite the big reader.
It's more of a hobby, honestly. It's just while I'm here, you know, trying to make it's a side hustle.
Side hustle. I can appreciate that. I deal in fortune tellings myself as sort of a side hustle when I'm not out adventuring with the rest of my party.
Ah,
so don't side-eye me.
Normally, fortune telling isn't named off as a side hustle. It's more of called a hobby or a side profession. When you're dealing with the fates of people, you don't really call it a hustle usually. Just saying.
Fair enough.
She will go. Maybe one day you'll have stories to write of your own.
Well, I can tell you this much, the stories we're currently making are interesting to say the least. But I wish you best luck in selling all of your wares. I'd actually like to take one of your history books about this land, if you have any.
Is there anything in particular, or are you just looking for general history?
More so general history. Unless you have anything maybe on... Is there even any actual recorded history of like sand devils or anything like that?
The other name for them is the king is the king and his six lords is another common title that are given to them, or the king and his lords and ladies. So there is some. Ooh, I almost knocked that empty bowl over. There is recorded history of them, but it's back to how accurate it is.
Right. Okay. Well, any knowledge
depending on you know the writer and his sources
and the winner writes the history books.
That's a good point.
Nobody won the war he's talking about.
Point still stands.
Just saying.
Any knowledge is better than nothing, so I'll ask for anything on the lord and or the king and his six lords and ladies.
All right. So she will produce a history book, and this will give you a +2 circumstance bonus to any history checks involving the lords or ladies. However, there's a chance the information you get will not be 100% correct.
Right. Understandable. Thank you very much. How much do I owe you?
This is pretty common. 7 silver.
Let's see if I can. I hope this is not gonna bite me in the ass. But let's see if I can roll a deception to kind of downplay the value of the book a little bit. I've got a library back in my hometown that I bet would probably have something similar to this for a bit cheaper of a price. If you're willing to negotiate, I'll roll deception for that. I'm feeling that is a yep. That's 27.
Okay.
Fucking you fancy motherfuckers and rolling higher than 10.
We both rolled a crit.
I give up. Use all of your crits now. You won't get another shot.
Of course I'm wasting it on buying a book that costs 7 silver, Awen, you cheap fuck. As if I didn't write the character this way, but fuck it.
Yeah, you cheap fuck.
Yeah, my... Yeah.
Alright, she will give it to you for 5 silver.
Alright, I can't ask for much more on a crit success.
Name the party the Penny Pinchers.
Honestly, that might not be a
It's not inaccurate. Well, thank you very much, and enjoy the rest of the festival.
As well.
Just take it a step farther. We can be the miserly.
Miserly?
Yep, the miserly.
What does that mean?
So a miser is somebody that's very frugal.
Oh, gotcha.
All right. Now you're really making me feel like a fucking old man. God damn.
Sorry.
You know how Scrooge is called a miser, Gage?
Yeah.
That.
Okay, that makes sense. So I'll turn around to leave, and I'll see just Mr. B just like staring intently at this book, just like. He's very much just like in the zone right now. I can imagine.
I can't wait until one of you accidentally summon a demon. Anyways.
All right, Mr. B, let's go.
Hey.
Oh, okay, thank you.
All right, so
I put my bag and start heading off.
It's probably still morning-ish getting in the afternoon, right?
Yes.
Okay. In that case, before we switch off, I will go ahead and probably start doing my thing. Performance, is that correct?
Performance!
Perform of the ass.
Perform of the ass.
7. Oh, it was close.
That's another... Wait, 5 plus 7, that's... 12?
12.
Hey, Jacob, can I assist? Like, maybe, like, cast some dancing lights or something to make it more...
Yeah. You could definitely, like, add a performance check to it, I imagine.
I'll let you roll a performance check, Josh, to see what you can drag in.
Dragon!
Dragon!
We
dragon
just
these fought. Nuts!
Don't holler a fucking dragon, you Justin.
So that's a 20. That's
20? Alright. So with the dancing lights, you are able to drag in a decent crowd with people coming by. So I'm going to... We'll hold off on that for now. We'll move on and we'll see how long the piece lasts.
Oh boy. God damn it. God damn it. I should have known.
You think I was gonna allow you to just have a beach day? Come on.
We had a beach day for a whole month.
I was gonna say the past 3 sessions have been beach days.
I'm still waiting, motherfucker, for someone to face me. I'd probably go over to the fucking fight, the one with the actual swords.
It's the same zone.
I know it is.
First, Noon, would you like to do anything?
I'm going with Rin.
Okay, Rin, what are you doing?
I'm Rin's bodyguard, basically, and there's a lot of fucking random-ass people everywhere, and fireworks and all this bullshit.
So, the fighting pit is the same pit that Gats is arm wrestling in, right? So we can't use that?
No, you can still use... There's a pit behind it. They're using the table.
Ah. Italo, you there for a fun round of sparring between us?
Sparring to the death.
He just has to make sure his threat is really setting in.
That's not threatening him.
Oh, I know.
Hi, buddy.
Well, it has been a while since I have been in a tussle. And we may need to de rust my skills before the bandit camp. Sure, why not? Let's try it.
Well, sounds like we're going to the pits.
I was hoping to play a chess game, but this is fine too.
You know, for the sake of for the sake of it, like, because my performance was so low, I'm gonna excuse that as Awen's also keeping an eye on this fight, just because, you know, he's already a little weirded out by Niccolo's behavior from last night.
Alright. So at the table they have all kinds of you know, different kinds of practice weapons, so you can take your pick. And this is a straight up dual skill bra. There's no guns. You gotta stab the man. So the ring itself is
the wooden stick.
Is quite small.
I'm going to pick up a training rapier.
Alright. Ooh, all right.
And you can attempt to push the person outside of the ring, and you win, or you make the person yield.
Okay, I see him pick up a wooden rapier. I unsheath my longsword, use an action to change it into a wooden rapier.
Oh, I see how we're doing this.
He's capping your flow.
The guy at the stand goes, show off. All right, take it, bets. Take it, bets.
All right.
Noon is going to
do a couple flourishes.
Noon is gonna put how much money do I have? Noon is gonna go put 2 gold on Rin.
It's probably the best bet.
the safer option.
He knows that binder better. Death, which will convert these to D10s if I roll a crit.
Uh-huh.
I forgot about that.
I did too, and I fucked that on you right. Anyways.
Gentlemen,
I made a good choice.
First combat, please roll initiative to see who gets to go first.
All
right. This time.
I like this.
Because I'm not stealthing. That's a 15.
Yikes.
That's a 21.
Thank you.
He knows first.
Alright.
Come on, buddy.
Alright.
Here they come.
Ooh. Oh. First combat. Alright.
Pass backwards. Let's pull those two people off.
Yeah, and I'll.
Was
ride myself over there.
This, that's one action. Okay. What does frighten do? Fuck.
It lowers all my stuff by one.
Okay, I will use my first action to demoralize you.
Right.
Oh god.
Alright, also made the will save. Bye-bye.
Oh. What?
I'm gonna be frightened too.
Critical success, you are frightened too.
Yeah,
wow.
Frightened too. That's fucked.
That's
what?
20s, boys.
What?
We're all gonna die.
The trend is.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Oh boy.
Okay.
Good luck.
Now.
Hold on to that 20, we need it.
I haven't rolled yet, which means all the ones are coming. They're all gonna be on me.
Yup.
This just means Josh, like, whenever he gets to the, like, the comet with the bandits, he's just gonna smoke all of them and we're gonna be fucked.
Well, I used one action for my movement to get to you. Demoralized, so I get
you,
one.
You
would attack.
Have started right next to each other.
Started
yeah,
right next to each
like...
other? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I don't know. I guess I could...
attack.
Well, attack, yeah. I get, attack first, I guess. That's a dirty 20.
All right, that hits.
Okay.
Only because you frightened me.
Yup.
So that is 8 damage. Oh man. I don't know what actions I can do. I already demoralized you. I guess I'll just try attack again with a -5.
God damn, dude.
Okay. Okay, 4. I see how this is going. That's
lower the amount of enemies in this next encounter, because I don't think your guys are gonna make it.
Wait, no. That's a -5, right? So.
So that's a 24.
That's a 24. Yeah, that's a crit. I can't change that to not a crit. Go ahead and roll your 2d8s.
And the modifier is doubled as well.
Yeah.
Correct. Okay. That's 8 plus. That is 16 more damage.
Alright.
Yeah, I agree, dude.
I see where we stand.
Oh my god!
I see where we stand.
Okay.
Is it too late to place a bet?
You can place a bet whenever you want. You cannot take a bet back.
Niccolo.
I'm gonna put 16 silver on Niccolo.
You dropped
16
your
silver on Niccolo. I now have to keep a running tab.
What is this RNG?
So, Niccolo, go ahead and make a perception.
A perception?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm fainting you.
Oh, a faint. Well, that's a 14.
So you're flat-footed. You now have -2 AC. Okay.
Oh, that's what I could have done for my other. Okay. Minus flat-footed. Okay.
Yep, I'm gonna roll the hit. That's a 17. Plus, hold on, I have to go over because I have a -2 plus 7, so 24.
I have an 18, so that's a hit.
At your -2?
Yes.
Alright.
Oh.
So then.
I think you
went in
on the dish.
That'd be a d6.
Okay.
That's 5 damage. Oh, okay. Sorry, I forgot to add my other d6 for my sneak attack. So that's 7 in total. And then, I'm going to roll the hit again. Oh, that might be a miss. I think that's a miss. Yeah, at a +2, that's a miss.
I would like to use...
Position low is 1.
Okay, so I took 5 damage total, is that what you said?
7 total.
7, okay, how the fuck do I adjust? I'll just do it on the character. Where's my character? Where am I?
Where am I?
You're in the ring.
Where's the ring? There it is. Over here. Thank you. I would like to use my reaction to use Iron Command because you did damage to me. I tell you to kneel. Kneel.
You don't tell them to walk out the ring.
No, I tell you to kneel.
Alright.
You can either drop prone as a free action, or you can refuse and I deal mental damage.
Alright, I'll drop prone.
Okay. So now it's my turn.
Yes.
Do I get anything since you are prone?
What?
Don't know the answer to that.
Hold on.
Grab the book.
Frightened one, add condition, prone.
I'm guessing you get like a +2 circumstance bonus or something.
I did a -2 AC.
Okay, he's considered flat-footed.
How long does that flat-footed last?
Oh, because you critted until the end of my next turn.
Okay.
Because I critted.
So it basically cancels out? Or no, his flat-footed only affects AC, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And you are
both have -2.
Because I critted, you are still frightened.
I'm frightened. 1, though.
Correct. Okay. Ah! Yeah. This combat.
Yes, use all the crits. Come on.
Make me some money.
Ooh. Here comes money!
That's a.
Here comes money!
I guess I'll try to hit you again.
-5 penalty.
Correct.
Which is a +4 to hit.
So that's a dirty 20.
And that'll hit only because I'm flat foot.
Okay.
I have an ability that stops you from doing that shit.
Oh, that is 12 damage.
That hit me. Have you not opened with that crit?
Yeah. Wait, did you say that knocked you?
Yeah, it knocked
you. Holy shit! Oh! Yeah!
I imagine this damage isn't permanent.
It is not, luckily for you. You are quite bruised up, though.
Yeah. That was a good fight.
I imagine I walk away from my second wrestling match and see the fight and go, it's gonna be Niccolo, put 16 gold on, or 16 fucking silver, and just 16 gold. Watch. If it was 16 gold, that would've been fucked.
So, but Rin, you lost really your 2 gold, sadly. Austin. So you effectively put in 1 gold, 6 silver.
Depends on what everybody else rolled too. Went for too. Who was the betting skewed towards?
Well, if you're
I'm lazy, I'm just gonna roll
just
a dice.
You and me.
Either the guy in scale mail with a shifting sword.
Just gonna roll a dice, and so long as it's above.
I can't move myself because we're in initiative, but. Yep. Noon would walk over at this point and just be like, that was disappointing. I put good money on you.
A little bit.
Alright, Austin, you will get 6 gold from that.
Alright. I lost my 69. So I'm at 74.
Just add 40 silver.
Oh, there we go. Now I'm back. That was weird. Disconnected for a second.
Am I able to step up on the ring while Niccolo is still up there? Just with a grin.
You can't.
Just crack. Crack.
Is that an intimidation?
Sure! If you want it to be, buddy.
I wasn't expecting Irby to go for that frighten right away. I was hoping my 22 AC would win me the fight.
Unfortunately, it did not.
Okay. So, I have my HP back.
Well.
Yes.
Okay.
That's not a very good intimidation at 11.
You would like to roll me initiative if you are indeed going.
Is there a greatsword in the training weapons?
Yes.
Wonderful.
Oh, wonderful.
Niccolo, the first thing you would notice would be Gats' fighting style, as he takes a stance that is very familiar to you.
Like, as into Niccolo the character, or to...
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The academy training.
Interesting. For a two-weapon-handed fighting.
Yeah, no, it's obviously botched, but it's still there.
Yeah.
Because I think that you're the...
It's like in Jedi Fallen Order, when the second sister is like, oh, I recognize that stance. That's one of the first you learn at the Jedi Temple.
But no, this is just the basic stance for, I don't know.
Yeah. Interesting.
Alright.
Sure. I changed my sword back to a long sword. Oh, wooden.
That's...
Wait, a rapier is a D6 damage.
That means Josh would still put up.
Fuck.
That's right, I forgot that they do different.
Oh, shenanigans! I lost good money on that cheating!
I gained good money, fuck you. Too late.
Too
it's okay.
Late. Fuck.
We've been right along.
I just noticed.
Is it just dex for
Perception.
Huh? Did I roll something? Oh, I did. I think I go first.
Yeah. I only have a plus 7. I don't have a plus 23.
I'm gonna demoralize you.
Oh, well.
Right.
Can I just grin? Okay, so what do I have to roll against that?
Fuck.
You want to roll against that?
I will.
Yeah, I might as well. I kind of have to, because if I also get a natural one, then we both are going to fail. It's a will save?
Yeah.
What the hell is that balance?
Against.
No, it's will of 19.
Your
will of 19.
Okay. So,
I'm just gonna grin.
I see. All right. Well, I just attack once. Plus 9. That's a 24.
Yeah, I'll hit.
Okay. Bop. 4. 6 damage, and then I will take the raised shield action.
I mean, that's the end of your turn?
Yes.
Austin!
I've yet to rage.
Oh boy.
I am gonna get water. Continue the combat on your own. You don't really need my input when it's you two.
Right. I jump in the middle of the fight.
By the way, taking bets. Wanna bet? Place it now.
Does anybody want to take a bet on this fight?
Okay.
I'm still doing my thing, so I can't.
Okay. Oh yeah, I don't know.
I would put 7 silver on Gats.
Rin?
I'll throw 2 gold on that.
Damn. Confident.
Oh, God.
It's gonna be embarrassing if he loses.
It would be.
Yeah, I'm still annoyed. I noticed that he is at the end
I'm
of
sorry.
Combat.
I added rapier to my weapons now. So now...
It finally clicked for you. I don't back to a long sword. I was like, fuck.
I did too. I was like... Rolled a d6,
I go back
didn't
to the longsword.
Whatever.
Whose turn is it?
It's Gats' turn.
I'm debating, and I was giving you guys some time to put in bets if you're gonna do it.
Master debating.
Master
debating. I'm funny.
I put 2 gold on Gats, Jacob.
I put 7 silver on Gats.
I just realized something.
I don't like it.
Oh, wait, that's a little different. I have something called the deny advantage.
Yeah.
Which means can't get flat-footed by people the same level or me or lower.
Huh. Well, shit.
Roads have it, too. But so that only applies to flanking, undetected.
Right.
Or hidden
it doesn't matter in this case when it comes to his abilities.
If they flank you, it's still flat.
Yep. Yeah. I'm gonna go ahead and rage as my first action. So, as per superstitious ability, I gain a +2 status bonus against all saves against magic. And I increase my damage from rage from 2 to 4 additional damage to creatures who can cast spells.
And I can cast a spell.
And then once every 10 minutes, when I rage, I can regain hit points equal to the temporary hit points you gain from that rage action. So, for my rage action that I would normally get is equal to my level plus constitution. So I get 6 additional health back.
Okay.
So basically the damage you just did to me, I just grin as it... The bruises... Or the metal unkinks. the metal unkinks.
Interesting.
What the hell? Heal. And then I'm gonna go ahead and hit ya.
Hit me.
I
have 22 right now.
I don't think I'm gonna hit that. Even with my +9, that's only an 18. And then with my second action, I want to try to take a meaty kick to your raised shield to kick you out of the ring.
Okay.
So athletics, I guess, Jacob?
Yep, athletics for both parties.
Damn it.
Damn. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think you win. Even with my +9, that's still only a 12.
I also have a +9.
That's kind of why I didn't want to do that, but I knew I wasn't going to get an attack off you with your raised shield with my minus 5. So I was like, I'll try it. Okay. But that's my turn, because I'm just grinning with my eyes now blazing and smoke bellowing from my mouth.
Interesting. Okay.
Funnily enough, the form is still there with the sword.
What other actions can I do? I don't want to... No, you specifically told me not to cast spells on you. Because I know you will...
You won't actually get killed.
You won't hold
especially
back.
While I am currently raging.
Exactly.
Might be a bad idea.
Shield block. Oh, I forgot I could do that. Whatever, it's fine. Okay, I guess I'll attempt to... Can you be frightened while raged?
I don't believe there's anything against that.
That is a 12 intimidation to demoralize you.
Because his demoralize come from his class abilities, does that count as magic, Jacob?
Any class can
divine.
Do it.
Divine. Okay, any class can do it.
An ability is different from magic. Unless it specifically has a magic tag. Yeah. No.
11 plus 7.
Attack once. I already forgot what it was. Plus 9. That's a...
No.
That's a 5. Nope. And then I'll raise shield again.
You're a bitch. Alright. I'm gonna hit him. I'm assuming that hits.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. 1d12 plus 6 instead of plus 4. No. Plus 8. So that's 11 plus 8.
Oh.
So 19.
Ooh.
Wait, I thought you were using a dreadsword.
Correct. It's a 1d12.
I thought dreadswords were 2d6 though.
Not from my book.
I would like to use my reaction to tell you to kneel.
I'm just going to grin.
Okay. You take damage.
Correct. Is that a divine ability?
It does have a divine tag, yes.
Then I take half.
Okay. 1d6. Mental damage, if that makes a difference.
It's divine, Matt. It comes from divine, so...
So you take one.
I don't. That's all.
Yeah, Dreadsword is 1d12. Neat.
So again, I will just continue to grin as I'm ignoring you. And now my second attack at minus 5.
Pretty sure that hits.
Oh.
Crit doesn't mean anything with attacks, right?
No, it does.
What does it do with attacks?
You double the damage in your modifiers.
On the modifiers, not the dice?
Both.
The dice, too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's everything.
Yes.
Everything. So should I just roll the dice twice? Or just double it?
Roll 2d12.
Okay.
Do plus, all,
plus 16.
Yeah.
So 17 plus 16.
I'm down.
Barbarians.
17. The 17 didn't kill me, but the 16 did.
So, I believe, Josh, you betted 2 gold. Someone else betted how much?
And I put 7 silver.
7 silver? Okay.
I'd shake off the rage. By the way, by the end of that, I think you did 1 damage to me after I healed.
Correct.
Fucking
not
hell.
Not that the damage mattered.
His barbarian's a little spicy because he can't be healed by spells. They counteract it with giving him regeneration.
Yeah. I will go ahead and lower my hand to pick him up.
Well fought. Whew.
Okay, I'm re-rolling that. That's...
I'll go.
Okay, Josh. Apparently there's a good-sized pot on this one.
Yeah?
So if 5 times return is what I'm seeing? Is that a 10 times return?
No, that's 12 gold.
12 gold return. So that's a 20 gold now.
They did just see Niccolo win. Yeah. And they hadn't seen Gats fight. They just seen him do arm wrestling.
You're a holt of a man.
You do be a big motherfucker.
You will be a big motherfucker.
I think the worst part about it is the fact that I took 1 damage out of all. And the 1
straight
damage
up
was you telling me to kneel and me going,
no.
Fuck you. No.
I'm curious how that would have played out if you had your D6s, Justin.
I had your 2 in the other round.
Get Jacob.
Yes?
What did I get? If he got 12 gold, what do I get?
Did you bet on Gats?
Yeah,
I put 7 silver on Gats.
Oh, you bet on Gats. I thought you bet on...
Oh, no.
Okay, cool.
No.
Always losing. Instead of the house always win, it's noon always loses.
Noon always loses.
You will get 7 gold back from that.
Alright.
7 silver to 7 gold. Way to go.
I'll take it.
Hell of an upgrade.
It makes back the money he lost.
Mm-hmm.
And then some. I have 31 gold now.
Fuck yeah.
You just see Gats is literally grinning ear to ear, like he's like enjoying the time of his life right now.
He will definitely enjoy this job that we are about to go on. When
slightly
it gets
more
hot.
Confident in our skills, yeah.
Barbarian's hurt.
Noon would kind of walk up to Gats and just be like, "For winning, I got paid."
Thanks for losing the list. I'm fucking taking over accents! Thanks for losing the last round. I got paid from you losing.
Ow. I feel like...
I just thought I'd make it up to you by beating Niccolo.
It's appreciated. I have a feeling that it'd be the, things might have went different. But it didn't, if he didn't lay me down like that one time.
I'm just gonna look over at Niccolo and like, stop hiding behind your shield there. Maybe next time you'll be able to hit me more. And he's just grinning like jokingly.
Damn.
Like he means it in like an honest like fight like a warrior to warrior sense, like as a joke. Like you can see he's actually chuckling
okay.
and smiling. Like well, it's meant of no disrespect.
Well, it was the style that I learned.
Oh. What you doing up there, Jacob?
I'm glad you noticed.
What did I not notice?
Are you in the center of town? right?
Yeah, this is. Wait, no, that's not me. Yeah, that's me.
So, bask in the bottle of the coin guard.
Oh, great.
This might be a change in music.
Hey, it might be. As the people who are now around the corner at the fighting pit would hear a commotion.
My face would instantly drop seeing more lizard folk.
Oh my god.
Okay.
So you say we hear a commotion?
Yes.
In what direction is this commotion?
Basically around the corner from the fight pit. Around the corner. I can get the right tool out. I mean, over here.
You see the armed patrol now marching down the street?
I noticed them when Jacob was actually moving them towards the center of town. I'm like, oh, fuck.
I'm about to get arrested, aren't I?
I feel like I'm about to get arrested.
You don't know my backstory, bud.
That's true, I don't know your backstory. That being said.
The fact that half the party might be, oh my god, I'm going to get arrested.
I know the little bit that Awen overheard when you were talking with Niccolo in the room, but that's it.
I Gats doesn't think he's about to get arrested. Gats thinks that he's about to get persecuted.
That too.
Yeah, are these roofs accurate to how the roofs actually look?
Yes.
Because I just see them from my angle. I'm just gonna shimmy. I wanna acrobatics up and stealth on this roof. Just shimmy.
It's just like see what spells I prepared for the day.
Do I end up on the roof pit?
Yes, you would. It is not that.
I'm gonna lay down low.
Oh, I don't like that 44.
With a 28 stealth.
That was 44? I thought that was 14.
It was 14.
I saw 14.
Oh, I read that wrong. That's my bad.
Where do you see the past rolls? There it is. I see.
Top right.
Yeah, I got a chat.
I'm
messages.
Just gonna fit a 28 stealth, and I will be on prone on this roof where no one can see me.
Can I try to stealth and go around the back of these houses?
You may certainly try.
I do love the. Oh no! It's the tops!
Run!
Basically, Gats and Niccolo would have been the fucking joking after the fight. And then you just hears the commotion, turns toward, and then he just like stops dead and just staring.
Yup.
So that's a 16, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 feet.
These cannot be good.
With I at 16 stealth.
Jacob, before I. Do I know who they're coming? Do I notice who they're walking towards?
Right now, they're just kind of walking towards the middle of town.
Not like, doesn't look like they're targeting anybody specifically.
At least not at the moment.
Okay. It's, I guess. Fuck, I'm in the middle of my, like, I'm in the middle of my whole thing right now. I don't want to, like, stop, but at the same time.
Keep going.
Stopping may be viewed as suspicious activity.
Well, I could probably just kind of, you know. Back up a bit to make sure I'm not in the way, and you know, try to get the crowd to come a little closer so they're not in the way of the coin guard.
A little closer, baby.
So back up a little bit more towards the tent, I guess. How do I move that way?
Oh no, I don't.
And then they're gonna start talking to people.
Oh no!
Where are you going?
The problem is the only other scaly fuck in this that I've noticed is me. So if they don't see Noon right away, they're probably just gonna look at the fucking metal man. If they are after Noon.
Okay. So is this like a turn so I can move again, Jacob?
Yes.
Okay. 25.
And you can see that all of the guards seem to be holding a piece of paper and showing it to people and interacting with people. You can roll me a perception to try and see what's on the paper.
I'm doing that right now.
Assuming you are within line of sight, of course.
Yeah, I don't think I'm in line of sight of anything going on
here. By the way, don't forget you can use all three actions to run, so you can do 25.
Oh shit, that's right.
What did I roll?
You rolled an 8.
What's plus 7? That's... Fuck, what's that? Is that 15?
Yeah,
15. Thank you. Fucking god.
I can't do fucking quick math.
I got a 22.
Dirty 20.
Alright.
Did I take the thing that lets me jump?
Joy, because you are working with a crowd of people, I'm going to give you a minus 2 circumstance.
That's
because you're working the crowd. And I think... And then anyone with anything less, everyone who rolled above a 14 could tell that it is definitely a wanted poster.
Okay.
Anyone above an 18, because of your distances from most people and the way they are facing, taking that into account, it would look like a very accurate picture of Noon.
Oh fuck! Oh no!
I knew it. I fucking knew it.
I'm gonna walk a little bit closer to this coin guard and look at the wanted poster that he has.
Can I make an attempt to try to get onto this roof now?
You may.
Okay, what do you want me to roll?
Athletics.
Either athletics or acrobatics.
Definitely athletics. I have a much higher boost to that. That's a 21.
There you go.
So
I take it I'm up with a 21?
21, yes.
Alright, so I'm gonna go up and also just kind of lay down.
All right. So,
kinda like here.
Get as you approach the wanted poster, it is very much definitely Noon's face with his mask off. It says the poster says, "Wanted, dead or alive." Bounty of 15 gold at the moment for breaking and entering. And the...
It dead says, or alive for breaking and entering? What?
There's more.
There's more. Breaking and entering. Potential attempted corporate sabotage. Potential kidnapping.
Fuck.
Is he passing out flyers, or he's just showing it around?
He's showing it around, being the distance they would have had to have traveled, and the amount of time it would take them. They probably would have left very quickly after you, so they wouldn't have had time to have gotten all of those made to just hand them out willy-nilly.
Did you say corporate, potential corporate sabotage?
Potential.
And potential kidnapping?
Yes.
Okay.
Here's...
Potential attempted kidnapping.
Attempted?
Attempted.
Okay. Attempted.
And potential sabotage. Okay.
Corporate sabotage.
Correct.
I really hope they come up to Mr. B.
Oh, no.
Oh,
no.
Oh, no.
Where did I put my fucking notes?
I am the wind. No one knows where I am currently.
Do I notice
my athletics
any,
was
any
better
people
than
around
myself,
us?
Unfortunately.
Jacob, do I notice any people around us pointing in the direction that Noon went?
He stealthed away, didn't he?
But he was here.
I stealthed away with a 16, but yes, I was there with a mask, but apparently...
They have both.
The image has my mask, so...
So, Dustin, even or odd for me, please?
Okay. Oh, fucking hell. You know how we do. Even.
It's gonna be odd.
Probably.
Oh, God, I've really got to put all my notes in one central location.
Oh, one of the guards was talking to one of the civilians, and, remember the guy that Awen said would have great fortune?
Fuck. Fuck. I knew this was gonna come back.
They bring the poster up to him, Gats would probably be the closest one to hear it. And he goes, yeah, I thought I saw him staying at that tavern over there.
What?
Yeah.
I'm gonna just nonchalantly look back at Niccolo, see if he heard that.
They would have been standing next to each other. So
that's a...
No, I move forward. So.
Oh, right.
Yeah. I can't ever remember. 19. That is a 17 perception.
17.
Wait, how do you only have a +5?
He's not...
Oh, you only trained in perception?
Correct.
Ah.
Jacob, would have he heard that as well? Standing nearby me? Niccolo,
17. If you...
You rolled 17.
Where is Niccolo currently?
Right there.
Oh yeah, he would have heard that.
Cool.
Okay. I'm just gonna side hide him, start walking towards the Awen, the Mr. B.
Alright. I follow him.
And I'm just gonna go.
That news, these three are gonna start moving towards the tavern that I haven't built yet, sadly.
I'm going to say, pack up. And
what?
I'm gonna start walking out of town.
Pack up? What are you talking about? What's going on?
I'm not saying anything else with them nearby. Yep. So he's literally just continuing to walk now.
Alrighty. I'll follow slowly behind as not to make it seem like I'm following him. Oh, don't go up the tent, Gage.
Can I roll a perception from the roof to see where they are going, J-Top?
Yeah.
If I can see the party moving.
And Irby, stop.
Okay.
Oh, no, that's an 11. I can't see them. I'm not moving.
Hello there.
One of the clan guard comes up to you and is like, have you seen this man?
I do not recognize him.
Deception.
You could have just... You already know that they know he was at the tavern. You could have just... Whatever.
But... I think I heard someone say that he might have been at the tavern.
Alright. What's your bonus?
2. That's an 11.
On.
I'm not a good liar.
He's getting detained.
Fuck.
He's getting detained.
Okay, hold on. Am I aware of what's going on behind me right now? Do I see Niccolo being?
Oh yeah, so you would see the tissue that is currently forming the problem at hand.
Oh no. Uh-oh.
And the guard that walked up. It's like, are you sure you don't know anything else? You do know withholding information is a crime.
Well, there are a lot of people here today. I might have seen him somewhere. But
hey, real quick, before anything else kicks off, I'm going to tell Mr. B. Mr. B, could you hold on to my cane for a second?
Yeah, sure.
And I am now going to start walking back towards them. He's going to start putting on a performance that kind of looks like he's drunk.
But as of his...
Or only a performance check?
Yes, sir.
Current whereabouts, I could not tell you.
Shit. Fuck.
Here's the bad rolls.
That's an 11, I think.
You're gonna have four. Fucking arrest you want out
I think
of
7
prison.
Plus 4 is 11, yeah.
Fuck.
Guard, you're actually... I believe that...
Oh, I was walking back towards Niccolo and the guards that are currently surrounding him.
You're actually standing directly next to a guard right now.
Oh,
so he's
well,
going to...
That's fitting.
Oh.
Oh, fuck!
He doesn't smell a lick of alcohol.
If we gotta go looking for attention, do it with someone who doesn't have a gun.
Understood. Thank you, officer. I'm just going to turn back around. Mr. B, may I have my cane back, please?
Yeah, sure.
You know what brought your hand into that? The dog saw you hand Mr. B the cane after watching knife, and then you told a stumble, he's like, no.
I would like ask everyone, like, hey, yo, what are they doing in here?
Oh.
If you understand, Mr. B.
No! God is dead.
He's dead. Like, he froze and everything.
Jeez.
You know, though.
God, why did I have to roll a nat 20 for a fucking book?
If any of you get arrested, I'm breaking you out of prison.
You hope.
Okay.
We've been told that fighting the coin guard is a bad idea, right?
Yeah, I know, we have.
That's why I'm not fighting them. But they'll probably detain you here that did everything in order.
There's a reason why Jacob has built a jail.
Before the tavern.
Yeah.
Not really.
Because
it was the central building in the town, and it was easier to build around the central building than anything else.
Yeah.
That makes sense. I just assumed that the cells are for them now.
Also for three criminals, you know, also makes sense.
Four.
Four.
One frame.
Yeah, come
on. Yeah. Niccolo isn't a criminal.
So...
Jacob, do you need me to re-stealth now that I'm on the roof, or am I just using the same...
You're just using the same. You weren't detected. You jumped.
Okay.
You haven't attacked anything, so you haven't broken stealth.
Alright.
And I'm sorry, with the Wi-Fi dying. Irby, I forgot what your fucking response was.
There are a lot of people around here today. I may have seen them, but as of any current whereabouts, I could not tell you.
I think you're technically telling the truth, because I don't think you saw him go up on the roof.
Nope.
No,
no, it wouldn't have.
We were distracted by the guards coming in.
And I forget, you are... What again, Irby?
Human.
What race are you?
Oh. A human.
Human. The coin guard will look you up in guard and go, alright, stay out of trouble.
Will do, sir. I need to change my pants. No, I don't say that.
That's a 19. Can I now see the party moving out of town?
Yes, you would be able to.
And the dogs. None of the dogs are looking this way, right?
At least not at the moment.
I'm gonna crawl over here and jump over as stealthily as I can. My initial 30 stealth, since I'm not going to try to break it.
God, that, this is a long hallway, Jesus Christ.
Athletics? Yeah.
It really is, isn't it?
That is a... 15.
15? Alright, yep. Want to be too hard?
Is there any guards watching the exit of town?
At least not at the moment, because not a ton of people saw them come in, so they're kind of going for a blitz.
A blitzkrieg trying to find Noon?
Yeah, it's like, can we find him before he gets the word that we're here?
Well,
it's too late.
At all.
Yeah, but they didn't expect you guys to be literally around the corner.
Yeah.
So, as... I think this is a cantrip. Yeah. So, a cantrip, I am going to use message to Rin and say, should we just leave now?
I see him on the roof with me and he doesn't see me. Jump roof.
Okay.
Thing is,
so,
no one realizes you've escaped. I'm gonna say this encounter is successfully passed. Congratulations.
Woo!
Oh God!
Gonna keep moving rooftops till I'm out of town.
Yep, Noon is fucking gone.
Gone, baby.
Gone like a freight train gone like yesterday. Soldier in the Civil War, bang bang.
Good morning.
Jacob, did I make any money from like the limited
yes.
amount of time I got to like work the crowd, or did I not have enough time to make
yep.
anything?
Yep, you would have made some cash.
And an eternal enemy. Namely.
Well, no, I wouldn't have made any enemies.
The fortune die.
No, so I think what Jacob was getting at with that one was like. Like, I told him that he was going to have good fortune, and he's the one to point out that Noon has been staying at the thing, so if they had caught Noon, he would have gotten the bounty.
Yeah, but he didn't. It's too
but,
to him.
Okay, but, you know.
Or that he missed his opportunity.
Yeah, that was a little bit of a joke. I don't believe you actually made an enemy.
You would have made a total of 23 gold!
Oh!
Damn!
Let's fucking go.
With the joint rolls and the fact that there's a shit ton of fucking people here right now.
That's a good point.
Are you splitting that gold with
yeah. the person? Yes, I am, actually.
Oh.
Mr. B, I would like to give you... Mr. B, do you you understand the concept of money and how it works, right? Like, you understand, like...
It's gold-colored?
I think what I'm getting at is like, you know, he's on the one hand, like I know that he knows what money is and that he has to use it, but like I'm wondering if
yeah.
he understands like the real value of what he's receiving.
I don't think at this point he would have like someone like, hey, you gotta give me 3 gold for this. Like, oh, okay. You know, like I don't think it'd be like how trade works or anything like that.
Okay, I'll say. I'll give you 5 gold.
Aw.
You bastard. You fucking puke.
Oh, wait till level
get
5.
Get the character!
You fuck. You're taking advantage of a baby. You're taking advantage of a child. You're a prick.
It's in character.
Eowyn was
taking character advantage to take
of
a candy
child.
From
I don't
a bandy?
Hear it.
Wow. It's in character to take candy from a baby?
That is actually.
Penny Pinchers.
See, Eowyn is like an episode of Extreme Cheapskates.
I like to reuse my dental floss.
Not that, okay, not like that. Like, sure, Eowyn's cheap, but he's not like unsanitary. Like,
no, like.
No, I clean it. I clean it after I use
it. I wash it.
I wash it just like I wash my toilet paper.
Eowyn does that, making butter out of coffee creamer.
73 silver here! Build an arm strength and save in silver!
Oh my god. That's so fucking funny.
I think that Mr. B was just kind of like,
oh. Jacob, would we have survived a combat with those coin guards?
You probably would have.
I was
only
so ready
because I don't. I have to try and do things a little on the lower side because I've never done Pathfinder combat before as a DM. So I need to find the baseline. So when I decide to throw harder things at you that aren't meant to kill you but still be a challenge, I can find the
fine tuning.
Yeah,
I saw a video on Pathfinder. It's like it's based off of the XP love rank or whatever something it is.
So if they did end up attacking and y'all died into combat, Rin was just going to blow one of their heads off from stealth immediately when they stabbed you.
I was planning to cut one in two.
After they stabbed us, it's very nice of you.
They wouldn't have stabbed, they would have shot us, Josh.
If they would have started fighting, Noon would have gotten down or gotten up from the rooftop and probably blown the head off of another one with a sudden bolt again.
So two would have been pink mist, and then Gats would have split one in two.
Nick, I'm really glad you gave me leeway when the guard caught me, like, trying to act drunk. I'm really glad that, like, that didn't turn into anything worse than it could have been.
Our first combat was ruined.
If you rolled higher, it would have been, what the fuck are you doing?
That's true. That's fair enough.
There are people, when cops are around, that just fucking try to make a scene just for no reason, just because they want to try to get arrested so they can get a free meal and a free night in jail.
I guess that's fair.
And with the way that you look...
Yeah.
You look like one of those people that look like they're trying to fish for a free night in the jail cell.
Free shit, shave, and shower.
So... Good work, everyone.
So, as we're leaving town and heading towards Iron Coast... So... Attempted kidnapping, huh?
I did tell you he fucked up.
So we should get a little further away from town, and I'll explain it all.
Oh yeah, I would have waited at least half an hour from town.
I never got to give Thompson the message I wanted to give him. The messenger.
What is the range on message? Let me look.
I even wrote it out.
120 feet. All right. Nope.
That's a nope right there.
It's not sending. So
honestly, I think Thompson will understand.
Are we like gone? There ain't no one around. Jacob.
Yep. At the moment, there's no one around.
As far as we know.
So, yes. Attempted kidnapping. Don't know what the hell they're talking about with corporate espionage.
I hadn't said that one yet.
I'm assuming I heard it. I mean,
you bolted and went on top of a roof. You did not hear shit.
Oh, okay. Fair enough. So yes, there was attempted kidnapping. I'd been living on the streets in the city for almost a year, maybe a little more than a year at that point. It all kind of ran together, and I was desperate. I needed money. I fucked up, and I tried to attempt to kidnap someone for ransom, and the homeowner saw me in the house, and I fled, and that's where Rin saved me and put me back on the path of, you know, not going to jail, and that's why I'm indebted to him and why I serve as his bodyguard for free.
Well, two things that I'm going to say before we settle down for camp tonight. One, give me your mask. Is your mask made out of metal?
No, it's basically like a bandana, but made for kobolds.
It's just a bandana?
Yeah, but made for kobolds, because we have snouts and not flat humanoid faces.
I'll come get...
Mr. B is stylized, doesn't he?
That's fair. Mr. B can stylize the mask to be different.
Yeah, we'd have to like have a short rest. I have to change it up.
That's fine. We'll be traveling for the next couple of days.
like, Mr. B, when you get a second, we might need to change up his mask to be something different so that way he's not as easily identified.
Okay, yeah.
Two. What did I... I'm just going to say, like, you're not exactly helping my idea of spellcasters thinking that they can get away with pretty much anything with the kidnapping. There are plenty of work that you can do on the street to get money.
I did not do what I did because I am a spellcaster. I did not cast any spells in my attempt either. The fact that I can use magic had no bearing on the actions I decided to make. They were my own, and I own up to that.
Not quite, since you're not, you know, turning yourself in. But when it's a dead or alive poster, I guess I understand that.
Who was it you tried to kidnap?
The son of a wealthy businessman, I guess. I'm not really 100% sure who he was. All I know is that he lived in a pretty nice section of town, and I figured he had money, and figured he would be willing to pay.
And there's the corporate sabotage.
Mm-hmm.
As well as the...
Trying to kidnap the heir of a... of a wealthy business, as well as getting money from said business could cripple it.
Yes. And the dead are alive. And the rich person who's...
They put dead or alive?
Mm-hmm.
Nobody got hurt.
Doesn't
that
matter
seems
when
like
you piss
some
off
bullshit.
Richmond. Doesn't matter when you piss off Richmond.
How much would they want him for him?
15 gold.
I'd scoff. Noon would scoff and be like, that's
be
it?
Happy. Be happy that they're not paying more, because then you'd have actual bounty hunters after you and not just petty thieves.
Petty officers.
I suppose you have a point there.
Count your blessings.
Anyway, I appreciate you guys not selling me out.
Of course.
I figured I'd at least hear the story from your mouth before I made my decision on that one.
You've raised my level of trust in you all. I will admit I am a bit of a skeptic at most times, and
bit.
Less than trusting.
How many of you did they see?
They talked with... I passed by one. A1 talked to another one, and Niccolo got nearly detained.
I don't think it was that close, but I talked my way out.
Yeah.
Is that a deception check, Justin?
He did talk his way out, though.
He did talk his way out, but...
yeah, I don't think I was that close to being detained.
Well...
you had three guards around you at one point.
Seeing how they didn't see me... might be wise to go back for one of us. To go back and pick up our stuff.
Did you guys leave your stuff at the tavern?
I'd like to think you don't care. Does everyone carry everything with them at all times?
Yes.
I don't have a lot of stuff. I don't have stuff.
Literally everyone but you, apparently.
No, I just...
Noon has everything he owns on
the tavern.
But if
I don't... fits in my backpack.
I don't stay at the tavern, so I don't have stuff there.
Awen kind of just like...
I knew I was wanted by the law. And two, I am your bodyguard. So of course I kept my weapons and all my belongings on me.
What did you say, Dave?
I was looking and seeing if there's really anything. Yeah, I guess I probably would have had a backpack on me. And
everything fits in my backpack. I just want to make sure everyone has the shit so that we don't get, well, where's your stuff?
have to go back and grab it later.
That's fair.
Does everyone have the stuff?
Plus our plan was leaving after the festival is over, so.
Yeah. Well, I also think we figured we were going to stay one more night anyways.
Yeah, Noon definitely carries his shit with him.
Yeah, Awen would too. He's that kind of, you know.
You're literally the traveling hobo. The rest of us either have reasons why to keep our stuff on or don't have stuff to leave anywhere.
Yeah, I'm like nothing.
So
I see you have a book now, Mr. B.
He's got a dictionary.
Yeah. Did you want me to read some of it to you?
Sure.
Read us a story.
A dictionary, my favorite bedtime
book. More natural.
Let me tell you a story of blood and sand.
I don't speak Natura, but I do speak Shadowton.
So did you have stuff still in town that you needed to retrieve?
No, I have everything in my backpack. I don't know how you do
anything. Okay.
If it fits in the backpack, I carry the backpack.
Yup.
I just know Awen's a traveling circus.
That means he has his hobo pack on one at all times.
Realistically, as long as I've got my money and my cards, Awen will ditch anything else that he doesn't deem necessary.
But that would line up to the bandit early, just then I've got my bag of salt.
Your bag of salt?
I did have some ideas about this bandit camp, but we can discuss that in the morning.
Yeah, one of my ideas is shot. I was gonna suggest we buy a caravan, like a small carriage, and break it down to lay a honey trap.
Interesting.
Not a bad plan.
But since we had to leave town in a hurry, no carriage.
Yes.
Was there a carriage shop in town, Jacob?
Not really.
Damn.
I could try to buy one off of a farmer, though.
Let us...
Right, there's no farmers nearby.
It would have been afternoon when that happened.
You're in a
desert.
I had to remind myself of that. There is no farmer here.
So why don't we keep walking and we'll discuss the plan. What did Nicolo happen now?
Well, you mentioned when we first got the job that you wanted to infiltrate the camp.
Yes.
Get some information. Maybe take out the leader. Gather numbers, yes. I agree with that plan. It would get a nice showcase of your skills.
Alright.
I did just have an idea, inspired by your cart, Ergats. If we want to draw them out, we could, have somebody, and I would volunteer, especially seeing as I am a kobold, and the, things that normally entails for one of my race, at least in our area of the world, I would volunteer to, act like a lone traveler that had ran out of supplies and maybe passed out along the sides of the road. Or you guys could wait in the wings and wait for them to come and, well, for lack of better terms, loot my body.
Not a bad plan.
That could work.
I feel like
as a kobold, I would be a, good potential target, as many of my race are fairly well off.
Mr. B, out of curiosity, do you require oxygen?
I don't know. I have to put my hands again now. So.
I don't think that's in Nicolo could be very stealthy. But we could bury Mr. B so we could look out of the pile of sand and see him coming.
Keep my head above.
Health option.
You can bury me
just like,
too, not that I'd be
like,
very appreciative of that.
Just like two little eye holes in like the sand and he just peers out of.
just like one of those military movies where it's just the top of their head sticking out of the river, only instead of a river, it's just a bunch of sand.
Yeah. And if your car is like, my friends buried me and then they left. They
and
like
sand guardian. Guardian of the sand.
Okay, Farron.
Pretend to be dead.
Poseidon quivers before him.
Back off.
Back off.
Maybe Michelor should pretend to be dead as well. Two bodies are a lot more enticing than one.
Well, I do not consider myself an actor.
Well, I suppose I could take the role. Not that I look like I have much on me to begin with. But I can try my best.
Yes.
We have a plan. Jacob, how far away are we from the roads that people jump at?
Those are just the main roads.
You said so they're usually around.
You would be on it if you're... I'm assuming you're traveling out of town. Unless you decided to attempt to navigate the desert.
No.
I don't think we're quite that stupid, Jacob.
We got in a rough location from Thompson, right? That was like around this area, correct? Or no?
I gotta pull up my map. Or I should be a dick. I don't know. What did he say?
I'm pretty sure it was the camp
was around the bridge.
Was
yeah,
around here
right,
somewhere.
Around this
in
area.
Here.
So, why don't we try to do it when we hit the bridge?
I think it was just before the bridge, on our side.
Would you do it at the bridge?
Yeah, and then we risk running into the coin guard heading on back.
Still doing the risk if we're on the road. You know. There's very little honor among thieves. The bandits probably know about Noon's bounty, and they probably saw the coin guard going through.
It's probably true.
It'd make a nice cash trap, too.
It would.
15 gold and have the money you how much money you have on you, Bob. I like that.
Yeah.
And you just escaped the town.
Exactly. I could see it working.
Alright, let us move down the road so we get to the jumping place.
Remember to keep at least one alive for questioning.
Yes. Oh, I think we should keep a few.
I will do my best, but I'm not gonna let them actually kill me.
I think we keep at least three. Dad, Nitro, I think you have a way of questioning people. That, with all due respect, you are terrifying.
Thank you.
Edwin, you don't strike me as the kind of man who gets the hands dirty with this kind of activity.
I suppose we'll have to see, won't we?
Oh, you like going for the fingers?
That's a weird answer.
The pliers in that hobo hat?
You actually asking?
Yeah, that's an honest question.
No, I do not have pliers, whatever those are.
So for removing teeth.
They're usually used in working leather and metal or other objects and crafting. But people in more sinister trades like use it for torture techniques.
Hmm.
That makes me feel like you do that.
Nicolo is also comfortable with the idea of torturing them.
Yes. They are bandits. They do not need mercy.
And Thompson did suggest torture.
I think he implied it.
They're bandits. They lost their rights as soon as they started preying on innocent lives.
Correct.
Wonderful. One agreement.
Death.
You guys saying that about bandits, and Noon just kind of, like, shrinks down a little bit because, like, if you're saying that about bandits, what do you truly think on the inside about him for attempting to kidnap a child?
That's why he's like, he's already like, yeah, I don't exactly condone that action. And you're not, and you may say you're trying to atone for it, but you're not turning yourself in, which is you avoiding atoning. And Gats is mine.
Shall we travel then?
Yes.
Travel mark. All right.
That's perfect.
Love it when my plans change.
Knowing you guys, this will not be the last time the plans change.
Oh, fuck no.
Hoping to buy a flare gun.
I like to think we handled the point guard rather well.
Yes.
I'm surprised at how peaceful that was, I'll be honest.
Me too.
Jacob, are you proud of us for handling that peacefully?
We're not complete murder hobos.
Alright, we'll kill him next time.
The thing is, we're about to go the exact opposite direction with these bandits. It's about to be a fucking slaughter fest.
Alright, so.
Stop here, right guys? Before the bridge?
Yeah.
Right.
So is that a 1-2 day travel?
2 day. To be in the same tile as the bridge.
I'm gonna go quickly take a piss, so if you need me for anything, I'll be back.
Wait, I thought you'd have a piss.
I'm not part of the conversation when it comes to tactics, so it doesn't matter for me.
I'm gonna get a drink real quick.
So, is this anything eventful happened the first day of travel, Jacob?
Nope.
Oh. Not at all. How do we tend to travel? Is it like in a straight line or
I don't know. How do you tend to travel?
That's what I'm trying to ask.
I guess it.
Where do you stand, Nidalol?
I'd probably be near the front. If not the front.
Why don't we take the next watch to Devon?
Yes, I would not mind that at all. Ships no, like, next month.
Are you comfortable watching with Awen for a night? Try to mix up our party interactions a little bit.
Not opposed to it. You did say noon, right?
Yes.
Just wanted to be sure, because I answered and then no one said anything. I'm like,
because everyone's done, the other people are done. I would like to talk to Nicolo the second night of travel. More out of town.
Congratulations, you made it to a new month! Yay! Oh, wait, unless you guys want to talk during
night.
Your...
not this day.
Not this day.
Well, it would have been this night when we switched watches.
Yep, that's what I meant, because I was switching days, and I was like, wait, do you want to talk?
Yeah, we need to talk. Why are
right. So who is doing watch with whom, and who, and what conversations take place?
I'll watch with Nicolo, and I don't know, what watch do you usually take? Nicolo, the first one, since you're human, you need the light.
Yeah.
First one. Alright. I know Dats and Mr. B only need 4 hours of rest.
Yeah, I was talking with Jacob about it. I don't know if, like, I don't know, but I was thinking, like, for a skeleton, it's like they basically kind of, or and like skeletons and zombies and stuff like do it to like repair themselves or No. Like, basically get the effects of a long rest. I was thinking, like, if I don't really use spell slots or anything, I don't think I have to necessarily do that.
Oh, that's nice.
But it isn't, like, stated anywhere, you know, like, oh, you have to take it or you take exhaustion. Or, like, I just think that makes sense.
I have no problem with that.
My organs won't shut down if I don't sleep.
You need like 4 hours of meditation as an elf.
Why need to on watch? I'll talk to him a little bit away from, like, on the other side.
You flipped shit, and I thought my fucking Tailspire crashed.
Oh yeah, the music cut out. That's why I paused. I don't want to be away from the party, but I want to be on the other side of Dats and the ones that don't sleep. Okay, so it says, additionally, while you don't sleep, you enter a state of for at least 4 hours, which lets your undead flesh reknit itself and recover. Many undead choose to rest when the sunlight is highest. So you do need a 4 hour rest to recover.
Okay. I guess I'd probably do that when everyone else does. Then, I mean, if I don't have to do it during the day, because that would kind of blow my cover, like, oh, this guy's gonna sit here.
It says most prefer to, but you don't have to.
Yeah.
So, Nicole.
Yes.
First off, I would like to thank you in proving that we can trust you.
That is my goal. I do wish to earn all of your trust.
The most trusting individual. But you didn't crash onto the Twin God. You didn't crash onto Awen.
What? Huh?
When you and Awen were in the room, when Nicolo was acting weird, and you're like, are you okay?
Yeah, but how would...
He was following me during my long walk, and he would have followed me into the tavern as well.
Wait, you followed him all the way back to the room? Because I don't remember you doing that.
I would have been outside.
He had to leave for work at that time.
Oh, right. So we just assumed that he would have just kept following you.
Correct.
Makes sense.
I would like to tell you I appreciate it. And I don't feel the need to follow you anymore.
I guess
you did put up a hell of a fight in the combat.
Yeah, that was fun.
Yeah.
But Gats, that is one motherfucker.
That looks like the kind of man who can fold you with your clothes on. Fold your clothes with your clothes.
Fold your clothes with you in them.
Yeah.
What?
Fold
my doing laundry with someone in it.
Is that an actual, like, turn of phrase?
Jiu-jitsu, the art of folding laundry with people in it.
Not a turn of phrase. It's not an actual one in jiu-jitsu, but...
Yes. But I did have one question for you. Or many questions, of course, but... The biggest question I have is, can the party know the secret?
No, they can't. Although, I will tell you, I won't tell you who out of respect for privacy, but there is another member who is a member.
Besides you and Noon?
Yes.
Okay.
Is it just a matter of trust? When they earn your trust?
They would prefer to remain silent
For the other people who do not know.
Yes, it is a matter of trust.
Okay. I ask because if what you say is true of Whispers of Joy, it may be a great tool. And if you disappear and they ask me where you are, I'm not a very good liar.
We will cross that bridge when we get there, initially.
Okay. I'm just addressing my concerns.
I appreciate that.
Are members only allowed down there?
You have to at least know about it. Would you like to go at some point?
Yes, I would like to see what the fuss is all about. I was hoping to do it in Redwater, but...
the situation did not permit?
I was hoping... Can we see the fireworks from here?
You would be able to, yes.
Ooh. Oh, those are pretty, aren't they?
Yes. Yes, they are.
I was hoping to purchase... a flare gun. You probably would have one down there. For inner infiltration. To signal to us if you needed help. But I guess we do not have the plan B this time.
But you have me.
If I need the help, I'll let you know somehow.
Okay. Not that I do not trust your skills. I just care for your safety.
It's appreciated. I mean, the coin god didn't see me.
Correct.
And I doubt you did.
No. No, I did not.
I was on the roof next to you.
Interesting.
Yeah. Noon was on the other roof. Attempting.
No one saw me go up there. That I'm aware of.
But I saw you over there, and you did not see me. You messaged me as opposed to whispering to me when I was 15 feet away from you.
Don't want to risk breaking stealth.
Well, I didn't know he was there either.
Yeah.
With his fuck, what did you roll, 30?
28. Let us watch. This is a good chat, Nicolo.
Excuse me. Good lord.
I asked about that. One other party member knows. Is there anything else I want to talk to you about? Talk to the flare gun? Okay, yeah.
This watch uneventful, or do I need to roll a perception check?
Nope, this watch is uneventful.
Cool.
Is there any... Okay, sorry. Who's doing the second watch?
I'll take second watch.
I mean, I'm still awake, so I was probably present for that conversation, just not saying much.
Well, you
wouldn't have heard us. We would have stepped back a little bit.
I actively went to the opposite end of where you were sitting.
Gotcha.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, I wasn't there for that, so.
Yeah, I voiced that because I know half the party doesn't fucking sleep.
Gotta make the time for quiet time talk.
All right, so second watch, boys, is there anything you guys would like to discuss?
Looking at the fireworks.
I'll probably join him. Because the watch is 4 hours, right?
That's three groups. That'd cover 8 hours. So. 2.5 hours? Right? And it comes out to 9. 2 hours 15? Close enough.
Whatever. It's not anywhere really need to get into the semantics of it.
Doesn't matter much with two people who are able to perception while still
three
being awake as well.
Yeah. Yep. So
It's a nice display, don't you think?
I think I still prefer the stars.
Nothing compares to the natural beauty of things, I suppose. But it is pretty impressive how close humans can get to recreating things that are wondrous in nature.
And yet be so destructive.
I suppose it's all a matter of perspective.
You ever think there's more to life than fighting?
All the time. I long for a life of safety, where I don't have to fear for my life, fear for the ones I care about every day, one where I can live in comfort and do what I want to do.
So I am different than most.
Why do you think that life is all about just a constant fight?
Well, not that I think that, but that's what seems to bring me the most joy. When I'm in a fight, a brawl, a tussle, or just feats of strength, it makes it feel like I'm, well...
in control?
I was gonna say whole again, but potentially, I guess. Blacksmithing is my one great love. I love it more than most things. But it's more like my job. When it comes to fighting, that just feels like I'm really living.
Does it not get tiring, though?
If anything, after a good battle, I feel refreshed. After the bout with Nicolo, I felt like I just... I felt as if stepped into a nice sunny day after a cool rainstorm.
I suppose we all have our greater comforts inside. What about you, Mr. B? What brings you great comfort in this world?
I was kind of listening to you guys. I really don't know. I don't know what brings me joy. I have fun with my friends, but there's nothing really to live for.
That's kind of where my question lied. I don't know why fighting brings me the sense of peace and joy that it does, because I know it's not what most people look for in life. So I wonder if there's supposed to be something more. But I suppose, Mr. B, that is what life is for, to find that silver lining.
Yeah.
Find what you're living for.
I mean, I liked it when we were doing the performance with the lights and the cards and stuff, but I don't know why. I don't really know. I don't know how long I've been here. I don't know, you know. Most of my life has just been a service to another, so freedom is, I don't know, freedom to find what I love in life, you know?
That's all you can ask for. And that was a beautiful performance, by the way. You really did help me out there.
Oh, thank you. It's almost like I'm a natural. I think at this point, kind of like talk about the Sabi stuff, Mr. B would summon Mr. D and kind of just look at him and huddle up close to him.
You're really close with that one, aren't you?
I guess our souls are together, but I don't know. He's on this journey of freedom, he's the only one who's really been with me until I met you guys, so, you know. I guess we're kind of brothers, I guess, in a way. We're best friends, I don't know.
The familial bond is a strong one. Hold on to it as tightly as you can, Mr. B. You never know when that goes away.
Oh, I hope it doesn't go away. That would be pretty sad.
The fact that both of us said at the same fucking time.
Yep. Yep.
You've seen some shit.
You've seen some shit.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you for accompanying us and trusting us, Mr. B.
Of course.
Thank both of you for opening yourselves up.
I like taking my shirt.
Ish. Right. Ish, but, you know, the sentiment's there. All right. I think that's all I'm going to do, unless either of you have anything you want to bring up.
I don't think so.
How's the watch go?
Uneventful.
Pog, he says.
Alright, I believe we have one more group, am I correct?
That would be just noon since three people died.
I was gonna say.
Yeah, that would be me.
Yeah, but me and Mr. B are still awake as well.
Well,
and
I
technically
have. Anyone. Yeah, everyone's awake.
So technically it goes from a three watch to a four watch. Gonna voice your concerns you have about how we think about bandits, Mr. Newman?
Nope. He's gonna sit in quiet contemplation unless somebody brings it up.
I think Mr. B would just kinda stare at him, just like
you're actively staring at me?
Yeah, just staring at you.
Okay. So I'm assuming I would notice that and I would ask you is there a reason you're kind of, you know, staring at me? So, not to sound like an asshole, but it's a little disturbing.
Sorry, I don't know. I don't, you know, like with the stuff we've learned, I don't know if you're. I mean, I don't know much with these bandits, but I heard they're not good, and hopefully you're not one of them.
Well, I'm not a bandit. I'll tell you that much.
You have a bandana. I thought that was like, I heard that a while ago. They wear bandanas and run around.
Bandana doesn't mean a bandit.
Oh.
Yeah, that's why I fucking snorted a bit, like.
But I will forgive you your assumption.
Okay, awesome, thank you. I think something that's been weighing heavy on Mr. B's mind is kind of, I think a few sessions ago we had like a little bit of an argument with Mr. D, and I just want to be like, I'm kind of reflecting on this, and I wanted to say sorry for arguing with you earlier, a while ago, but I wish I could repay you in some way, you know, for the way I acted. I mean, I should have.
I would apologize as well. I must admit the undead is not something that sits overly comfortable with me. And having known you for just a short amount of time, even now, but especially at that point, it unnerved me. But you have already paid me back by, well, not selling me out to the Queen Guard. So,
who are them?
Thank you. The ones that came into town questioning where I was.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah, of course. And I'm just like, well, he can't smile, but he kind of like puts the thumb up. Like, yeah.
You know, Noon, I will say I don't quite share the same beliefs that Gats does in that all criminals are inherently evil.
I didn't say all criminals. Bandits are usually just the worst. Because they go after travelers on the road who are just looking to better themselves. The kidnapping part is still not exactly something I'm comfortable with. But again, I understand desperate people being desperate.
I don't want you to think that any of us are looking at you as a liability, or that you are not, that you are, you know, someone that we can't at least put a little bit of our faith into. We've all had to do things in our lives to get where we are today.
I haven't really done much legal.
Perhaps now you understand my actions in the necromancer's lair and why I do not wish to be, well, anywhere near the inside of a jail cell. It would not be hard for them to figure out who I was once I was in their possession.
Yes. Reputation can, as I've said before, put us in very precarious situations that I think we'd rather avoid.
Indeed. And as you can see, my reputation, well, I have some atonement to make.
Well, at the least, it's nice of Rin to take you in under his wing while you go through that atonement. You two are close, I can tell.
I owe him my freedom. And if you are not free, what is worth living for?
Well said.
Just wish I could 100% share that sentiment.
If you're not free, what's worth living for? Why do you not share, if you don't mind my asking?
I'm just gonna just look down at his hands. Just like flex and unflex his claws. Just kind of look back over.
Not sure Noon would understand.
Yeah. I didn't choose to be put inside this body.
So I suppose.
A little bit of me is fully trapped in that room with those mages.
But when you think about it, did I choose to be a kobold? I did not. My parents were kobolds, and thus I am a kobold. I did not choose my race or my color. My physical form was not chosen by me. Just as yours was not chosen by you.
He's just gonna stand up and say, the difference is that you've always been a kobold. I used to be myself, and they took that away from me. And I will never be able to get that back.
I suppose I see where you're coming from. I'm sorry they did that to you.
There's a reason why I think the way I do about mages. Again, I know it's short-sighted and self-serving, but I don't really care.
Perhaps. Should we travel together long enough, you'll learn to realize not all mages are inherently bad. At least I certainly hope you do not think of me that way. And if you do, hopefully I can prove you wrong. Although, with today's events, I'm not sure, not sure that's going to happen very quickly. Now that you know more about me.
Right. Unfortunately, my guard is already up when it comes to spellcasters. it was gonna take time no matter who you were. So prove me wrong. And Gats is gonna kind of walk a little ways from camp. And kind of away from where the fireworks are so that we can look up in the opposite direction and keep looking out over to the stars.
Alright.
I have to say, you all are an interesting bunch. I wasn't quite sure about everything when I first met you all, but given what I've seen the past few days, I don't know. I have a good feeling about all of us.
Then we all get struck by lightning and die.
Except for Catherine, he's over in the distance. I get away from fireballs.
You get hit in the back of the head by a firework.
Damn it.
Wouldn't he be the one that gets struck by lightning? He's the metal man.
That's true.
Oh yeah.
Is it magical?
He's a moving lightning rod.
That was good though.
Really good.
And I love it when I don't have to force people to fucking conversate.
Character development.
Thankfully this is thankfully.
That was not pointed. That was not pointed at anyone specifically, now was it, guys?
This way, that was not pointed at anyone specifically in this chat.
Yeah.
Rip.
Thankfully, this is only my second. This is my first time working a lot harder.
It may have been pointed at somebody that was going to be in this campaign,
and then wasn't.
But
dropped out at the last minute.
But. That was good to develop. I'm glad that y'all talked with each other.
Yeah. I organized my notes a little bit more.
I'm surprised that you didn't want to talk to me, Justin.
Well, I needed to confirm that secret. I need to do that first. I'll eventually have a conversation with Gats. It's coming.
Oh yeah, it'll come eventually.
Justin just has to prepare. That's why I love this every other week thing. I really do.
Gives you more time to prepare.
Yeah.
He has to mentally prepare for every conversation.
Like, honestly.
Honestly, I'm really glad I made this character the way that I did, because like I really wanted to test my improv skills with this one.
I enjoy Awen.
He's fun. I like him. I'm really interested to see how fucking Justin's gonna fuck me over with my backstory.
Jacob, you mean?
Jacob, sorry.
I was gonna say, what am I gonna do?
Gats is the perfect mixture of meathead and, like,
philosopher?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, passive perception.
My bad. I was basically saying, like, I'm glad I made Awen the way that I did, but I'm very scared to see how Justin's going to fuck with me in my backstory. Or and Jacob, said, fuck! I did it again!
He said Justin, and I directed him to J-Dub.
Gotcha.
But I'm also excited to see the Wednesday Dame group.
You saw how he fucked with my backstory, so...
Uh-huh. And I'm sure there'll be more.
So, passive perception. Many abilities are compared to your perception DC to determine whether they succeed.
Ah.
Your perception DC is 10 plus your perception modifier.
Oh, that's
a
natural
17. That's not bad.
It works the exact same way.
Huh.
Exact same way.
I didn't know it was in here.
Wait, you said it was 10 plus the perception modifier? So it's not the... But does the initiative bonus count towards that or no?
Well, no. The initiative bonus initiative is your perception, yeah. But if you have something that adds initiative bonus, it does not add passive perception bonus. Yes.
Like, I have something that gives me an additional bonus to my initiative, so that would not count towards my perception.
That makes sense. I also had another question about, like, combat and shit like that. I was looking at my, some of my weapons and shit, and I noticed that, like, my curved swords have something critical specialization on them. Yeah. Everybody's has that, or is that just okay? All is that different for every? Is that different for everybody? Like depending on what you picked.
Hey, I think different weapons have different
critical specialization
effects.
Great sword target is made off balance by your attack becoming flat footed until the start of your next turn. Oh, so
that's
you are flat footed too.
Well, you don't have access to your crit specialization yet. I don't think.
You don't?
Really?
Yeah, hold on.
I don't think you get it until you're master with the weapons. With the weapon, or something like that.
How do you become master with the weapons?
Yeah, it's the
it just kind of happens passively as you level up.
You get training proficiencies.
Gotcha. That makes sense. I can't wait to use my fucking swords. I've got two like curved fucking agile swords. I'm really excited to use those.
I can't wait to use my greatsword in actual combat.
I know.
I just have a big old bastard sword that would be a one-handed sword for most people, but as I am a kobold, it is a two-handed weapon for me.
So basically, you're
most of the time.
Just a small version of Gats.
At level 5, you get your critical specialization for melee weapons and unarmed attacks on barbarian.
That's why I have the raise a tome feat, so instead of having to try to carry a shield, I can use a book as a shield, and it's much lighter, allowing me to, you know, still actually be able to use my bastard sword.
That's pretty awesome, actually.
Is there anything else we want to do tonight, or are we going to cut it early so that we can drop the message?
Let's be real, the next thing is combat.
Yeah.
That's 100% guaranteed at this point. You're on the road to look for a fight.
Yep.
Unless we do anything in the morning,
which I don't think we will.
I already said keep one, at least one alive. So
we had the strategy.
Yeah. Any further strategy we need for the bandit camp we'll have to wait.
After we take
Till we get more information.
Yep. This was fun. I'm glad we subverted the coin god combat.
Mm-hmm.
Woof.
It's a little weird when you saw them.
Yeah, I don't think attacking the coin guard in the streets would have been a good idea because then that would have made a...
Definitely not.
Would have made us all wanted dead or alive instead of just me?
Yes.
Well, it's also the fact that then that town's just gonna get attacked by the military.
Did they upset something to Austin?
Yeah, what's up?
Just so you know, the Festivals of Glory is a week long when you're talking about celebrations, and that's the month you're in. That starts on the 22nd and goes until the end of the month.
Ah, okay, that's the yellow. Okay. It's not the yellow ones.
Okay.
More pit fights is what I'm hearing.
Pit fight.
And he's gonna give me more opportunities to fight against the fucking sand devil.
You're welcome.
Maybe round 2 with Nina Nicolo?
Oh, I'll kick your ass.
I like how he asked for a Nina Nicolo, but not for Gats.
No!
He only war does he use the D8?
That's fair. Yeah.
He might have. Well, how much health did you have left, Justin?
I got hit once.
How much health did you have?
I had minus whatever it is, minus 7. I was in the 30s still.
Josh, you that amount of damage even then, he would have been able to hit you one more time. You would have gone unconscious. You still would have lost.
No, I would have lost the frightened condition and had 22 AC.
Until I just do it again.
Yeah.
I mean, then I have 21 AC, assuming you don't crit it.
Is the target immune for 24 hours? Because I know there's a lot of effects like that.
I can double check.
The fact that you can just continue to frighten them is kind of bull.
Immune for 10 minutes.
Then, so you would not have been able to do it.
Okay.
And then I would have been able to dodge your attacks and had a higher plus to flat footing you.
Alright. I'm here and that's the end. Yep. Congratulations, you made it to the start of a new month.
Woo!
Yay. Does that mean we level up?
No!
Straight up, I want you to know that wasn't serious.
We haven't even done one full combat.
And yes, the more times you ask me if you level up, the longer it'll take for you to level up.
Hold on, let me set a math co-op to just send that to J-Dub through Discord.
I cannot wait for actual combat. Because just getting a taste of it with against Justin, I'll be honest, I didn't get a lot. it was kind of over immediately.
You hit me twice, yeah.
He hit
once, he tried a kick, the kick failed, he then went and did one hit the next turn, and
your classic
fucking...
just total side note, I was, you know, skimming through the, monster manuals, as a DM does, you know. Found a sand giant.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Fuck.
That one has a lot of fun monsters. Have you looked at the war swan?
No, I have not.
Think of it as a massive mass of corpses.
I have found the, I think it's like guard patrol and skeleton warriors very fucking interesting. Because they can form a shield wall. And they can attack 3 times, and their maximum damage is like 48 plus like 10 or 12. If they use that as 3 attack. I think it specifies they attack everyone within 10 feet. I'm like, damn!
Damn!
That's fun. I just kind of feel bad the fact that I literally only took 1 damage from in that fight. Against Nikola, because the other damage that he did initially, I healed him.
And it was on a reaction too. That's the funny part.
So parties.
I'm super excited to try out Noon and stretch Noon's legs playing as a Magus in the first real combat.
Yeah,
I'm super excited for that.
They watched it happen twice. Is the best part about that from the crowd perspective, because they watched him do it to
Rin.
Yep.
And then win the fight from it, because it looked like he was going to lose the fight up until that point. And then he said, kneel. The guy fucking kneeled. They're like, oh, that's fucking weird. That's cool. And then he tried to do it with the big metal man. Kneel.
Nope.
Grin.
I couldn't afford to take the damage.
Happens.
Yeah.
I mostly just, like, I've never done Pathfinder combat before, so I'm really interested to just see how it goes.
The 3-action autonomy is amazing.
I went back to 5th edition, and I went autopilot on Pathfinder, and I'm like, oh, look at all this stuff I can do, da-da-da-da-da, and everyone's like, wait, how are you doing that? I'm like, fuck, I can't do half what I just did. God, Pathfinder is just so much better. At least I think it is.
And then I still see people on TikTok like, oh, Pathfinder's not good.
People are like, Wizards is a great company.
They're not saying that. They're like, yeah, we don't like Wizards and what they're doing, but I'm not going to fucking play Pathfinder. It's just D&D. And then everyone else is like, no.
That's not how that works.
First edition Pathfinder may have been based roughly on 3.5, but second edition has nothing to do with 5e. Third edition isn't going to come out for a long time, because this came out in 2019.
Dang.
Yeah, Pathfinder 2E came out like 4 years ago.
But they've been slowly releasing content from it. So like when it first started, they had like the 5 basic classes, and then they, 2019, and then they've been releasing it like every 6 months with another 2 classes.
Yeah, classes from first edition Pathfinder amped up to 2E. My level 5 side hit did 74 damage on a crit. Yeah, a cleric walked into a teleportation circle.
I will be right back, boys.
Teleported into a room with a monster, and I was like, well, I'm probably going to have to save this new guy so that, you know, the party actually likes me. So I walked in and ripped off a third of its health, basically. Then I was like, alright, don't fuck with the pirate rat man.
Don't fuck with the pirate.
Yeah, I have a pirate head and a parrot with a paid leg. The parrot with the paid leg is my familiar.
So...
His name is Cheese.
I straight up did write a letter to Zerk the Sheriff.
No, you don't even get to say
like,
it.
I spent like over 10 minutes writing this thing. And... it was just like, I write to inform you that my party will be near the great city of Iron Coast.
Mm-hmm. D&D for you, man.
Good happen.
Whatever.
You know, maybe you descended on the body of a bandit. Justin, you descended to the coin god.
When they walk past?
Yeah.
Hey, can you give this to Zerk?
Alright. I think I'm gonna yeet on out of here.
Yep.
Try to get a little bit of something done before I go to bed.
Alright. I need to do the same thing.
Yeah, I'll call you, y'all.
Alright.
See ya, Josh.
Bam.